Huge. How are things at Buck and Honey's?
What happened? Tell us what's going on. How come there's no Will
today? Well, when I planned on coming down, we were hoping that the bus would get there, and we have an event tonight at Buck and Honey's. Yeah. And you know that Buck and Honey's holds a very special place in my heart, regardless of the fact that I didn't come there. Because not only is Tommy a good friend of ours.
Yeah, you haven't come to a Buck and Honey's, though. And you've had,
but the very... Yes, I have. I actually ate at one more recently than probably any restaurant other than Rustique in Green Bay.
Okay.
I ate at the one in the Monona right off the Beltline. It was great, by the way.
Oh, good one.
Yeah. But it holds a very special place in my heart, not only because Tommy's been such a good friend of the show, but the very first... Wilde and Tausch remote when our show first began way back in 2016 was at Buck and Honey's. So it always has had a special place in my heart. But I had to come back right after the show today. So I heard you were buying lunch for the entire team out of your own pocket.
Yeah.
Which I think is great.
What lunch too.
You're so generous.
That's why I'm here.
I just don't. Yeah, I was surprised. I thought, you know, this could be fun. And you know what? In fairness, Jesse thought like that the tailgate tour was going to just hang out in Sun Prairie.
So did I.
I don't understand.
Do you guys understand what tailgate tours
no.
are? You don't sit in one spot. You're on a bus.
So I know they've got, like, the stops in Beloit and Wausau and all the places that they've been this week. But what else do they – like, what do you do during the day? Because the event is later today at Angel Park here in Sun Prairie, benefiting Sunshine Play. It's awesome. Like, they're doing this later. So what are Bulaga and Mark Murphy and Mike Daniels and what are they doing right now? Or in 2 hours,
like they go stop at a school, or they stop at a children's hospital, or they stop at local communities on the way. You try to hit a bunch of spots. I believe they're in Platteville last night. I don't know. Hopefully, trivia is Platteville to Sun Prairie, Wisconsin today.
Not geography.
My guess is you're going to probably hit a couple spots on the way. What do you think? They just come plop down and say, "All right, we'll see you at 5 o'clock." Like that's not how tailgates work.
Do you stay in a hotel or do you sleep on the bus all week? Like
no, you stay in a hotel.
So they got to be in a hotel somewhere.
So in Platteville would be my guess. That's where the event was last night. Then they get up, they have breakfast, then they go and have another stop. They'll do another stop before they come here.
This isn't common knowledge for the rest of us.
How it is not common knowledge when you hear the word tailgate tour, do you just assume someone goes and it's not called the Sun Prairie Pit Stop or the Platteville Pit Stop. It's a tailgate tour. And the fact that both of you guys didn't comprehend that kind of blows my mind.
All right, so if I may briefly defend my honor, I understand that the tailgate tour.
I don't think you did.
Requires
because I think you bailed because you thought, well, those guys aren't even going to be there. I'm not coming. What do you mean they're not there? It's the tailgate tour. You thought they'd just be hanging out at this gas station across the street from Buck and Honey's waiting to come over. I'm dumbfounded by your guys' idiocy on this.
I will wear the idiocy comment just fine.
Jesse this week was literally when I told him it was like I slapped him across the face. What do you mean they're not going to be there at 9 in the morning? It's in Sun Prairie all day, no?
So I was under the impression, as having not attended the tailgate tour or ridden the bus, I did follow it to one destination many years ago to its like first stop, but I thought, all right, so they were in Platteville last night. I figured the bus then makes the drive from Platteville to Sun Prairie overnight. They stay at one of the more luxurious hotels in the greater Sun Prairie area. And then they do a bunch of stops in Sun Prairie. Mm-hmm. They go to the high school or the middle school. They go to a daycare center. They go to an old folks home. Then they... do their event tonight, and there might be some time within their schedule to hang out with us at Buck and Honey's and enjoy the great food and have a bunch of guests on the show. And when Jesse informed me that was not in the offing, he said, you know, so if you don't want to come down, it's okay. And if Jesse, who I think is our boss, sort of.
Yeah, I don't think he's he's definitely not my boss. I can assure you of that. I can't speak for you, but I know for certain he's not mine.
So when he said that, when the boss sort of says that you don't have to come, I said, well, okay, then I guess I won't. So it is 5 hours in the car. I got a lot to do today. It is a long round trip. You don't come to visit me very often up here in Green Bay, and that's fine. I don't hold a grudge, but apparently you hold one. You were very much looking forward to seeing me.
I'm not even going to go down that road. That's fair. I mean, you guys, the comprehension level on y'all's understanding of tailgate tours is mesmerizing to me. Like, it's just dumbfounding.
So are some of our ardent fans, like, Buck and Honey's doesn't do breakfast on Thursday, right?
Brunch on the weekends.
Yeah, it's brunch on the weekends.
But today's Friday, so there is no brunch
I'll tell you what's exciting, though, and this would have been something, because I know we've always been trying to find you a hobby, and you have none, and then you got into pressure washing. They got a great patio at the Monona one there, but they have a great patio at the Sun Prairie location, and they're pressure washing it. That means you know it's getting close to patio season here too. They got it's all going to be all nice and cleaned out. I don't want to speak for Tommy and the team at Buck and Honey's. I think the patio is going to be open this weekend. I'm going to put it on them. I think they're going to open the patio.
It's supposed to be like 70 degrees.
Yeah,
that would be great.
Let's get it open, Tommy. Let's go. I think Buck and Honey's patio, it's the best. Come on out all weekend long. I think the patio will be open.
Well, we certainly love our partnership with them, and we love Tommy and everyone over there. I guess now would be the time where I ask, though, since you're still working to get the video stream operating down there at Buck and Honey's.
Yeah, we're working on it. Sorry.
I'm not criticizing. I'm just pointing it out. And the people that are watching the YouTube or Twitter, I'm not even retweeting it right now because it's just me. I would be curious, what do we expect to occur during the window of our show with the tailgate tour? And I ask the tailgate tour expert that is Mark Tauscher, since we're, I believe, idiots when it comes to the tailgate tour. Like, is Mark Murphy going to swing by at some point to hang out with you guys? Because then I would say there's a better chance of that now that I didn't come down. Is Bulaga going to stop by? Like, do we have any idea if anything tailgate tour related will in fact occur during the 9 to noon window on which Wilde and Tausch is on the air?
No, there was never going to be. That's why I don't comprehend what. No. Is there, I believe, Jesse, as the content creator of this show.
Mm-hmm.
I believe somebody's calling in, right, from
the
bus?
So here's what I can share.
Oh, yes.
Oh, boy.
So during the 10 o'clock hour, they will be en route to wherever they're going. I'm sure Tausch knows everything
They'll
be on their way somewhere.
No, there's a bus. They parked out right in front of Buckeye.
No, there's not.
From the east side of Sun Prairie to the west side of Sun Prairie.
Yeah, they're camping. So. They actually just started a fire out there. They're going to start a little campfire.
We have been told, and we are in talks about someone on the bus will be calling in to join us while they're en route. So we'll get a live glimpse into what's going on the bus. Now, the latest update that I have is they're kind of all passing off, like, who's going to be on the phone with us. So Bulaga's on the bus. We don't want to talk to him because we talk to him all the time. Yeah. So Bulaga's nominating Rasheed Walker. Walker saying, it should be Kenny. And then Kenny saying, it should be Alex Green. So I don't know who's going to talk to us. It could be Mark Murphy by the time we get to 10 o'clock.
I feel fairly confident.
We don't know when they're calling. We don't know who's calling. Yeah. For all we know, someone could pretend to call in and be Mark Murphy, and we might have to believe him.
The rumor is it might be Shohei's interpreter. That is who may be our guest.
I would love to talk to the bus driver if the bus driver did call in. Probably can't talk while he or she is driving, but
it's probably fair.
They can pull over.
Well, I guess we're locked into the bus driver now for sure, because when it gets back to the bus that you've said, I would actually like to talk to the bus driver, even Alex Green is like, sure, sounds great. We'll go get some late lunch, early lunch, late breakfast. All right. Well, we'll get ready for whomever decides to join us from the tailgate tour bus. I can tell you this, Rob Domofsky is not on the bus, but he is scheduled to appear coming up at the bottom of the hour. So before we get to him, we're going to talk a little bit about the aforementioned Rasheed Walker, who he wrote about for today or yesterday, and I wrote about for tomorrow. What is his role actually going to look like, and how is he approaching the possibility that the Packers will pick an offensive lineman with their first-round pick? We'll talk about that, and we'll talk to Rob coming up after Tausch tells us about his love, not just for Buck and Honey's, but for Gina Della and Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
Indeed, you can turn your ordinary space into something extraordinary with brand-new Pella Windows and Doors. The luxurious look, the sleek design, and the custom colors available are guaranteed to give your home that extra pop to entertain and to keep you comfortable. It's the best of both worlds. Plus, getting the perfect windows and doors for your home has never been easier. Right now, get 0% interest for up to 36 months. No, or you can have no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th. Take ownership of your living space and make it a place worth living with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
There they are. If you're watching on the video stream,
we're on
we
TV,
have
Tausch.
Connectivity.
Oh, what a world, huh? What a world.
Tausch's attitude is great. You would think that he'd actually be happier that I didn't come down, which is a little perplexing. But nevertheless, Tausch is excited to be at Buck and Honey's with Jesse. We got Riley Yauch. That is not his penultimate show with us, hopefully. But he is working from the Everlight Solar ESPN Madison studios. I'm here in Green Bay. The tailgate tour bus for the Packers rolls on. Rob Domofsky scheduled to appear later in the hour. We'll talk about Rasheed Walker next. It's Wilde and Tausch.
Wilde and Tausch is presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Call Gina Della from Pella at 855-PELLA-WI or visit online at PellaWI.com/radio.
Hey, it's Ben Bruston. Join me for a look back on one of the most memorable basketball seasons in Badger history. A banner year, the story of the 2014 Wisconsin Final Four team, featuring great conversations with Bo Ryan, Frank Kaminsky, Barstool Big Cat, Ian Eagle, and more.
It is all over. Wisconsin is headed to the Final Four.
Find it on ESPN Milwaukee's YouTube, live on 94.5 ESPN, and wherever you get your podcast.
Hi, this is John Neal, CPA, founder of Right Choice Tax Resolution, and best-selling author on how to have less stress with the IRS. It's 2024 and an election year. The politicians are out there promising things they won't deliver. One thing is certain, taxes are what pays for those promises. The IRS collects those taxes, and man, can they be brutal. My latest book has advice on what to do to avoid trouble with the IRS. We help you file back tax returns, get liens released, set up payment plans, represent you in audits, and get penalties reduced or eliminated. Some recent clients we helped include getting a $40,000 tax bill reduced by $32,000, filing a 2020 tax return to get a $7,000 refund, and negotiating a payment plan for $250 a month on a $30,000 tax bill. Make the right choice. Go to rightchoicetax.us to book a call or in-person meeting right now. We know you want to take the first step in getting the IRS off your back so you can live again. That's rightchoicetax.us.
It's our lowest prices of the season at Blaine's Farm and Fleet. Right now, shop unbeatable deals on the things you need for spring, like select sizes of Meow Mix cat food, just $16.99. Get a free bag of Estate Garden Fertilizer when you buy new Estate Premium 4-in-1 Lawn Treatment. Assorted brake pads, rotors, and suspension parts, 20% off. And 50-pound bags of Diamond Crystal Natural Solar Salt, $5.99 each. Don't miss our lowest prices of the season in-store or online at farmandfleet.com.
Brian, why are you stacking books on the floor?
I want to stand while I work. Standing desks are all the rage these days.
Well, it's a good thing that these desks move up and down. You did know that, right?
What? They do?
Yeah, we're not messing around here.
This is great. Now, only if I had a chair to swivel around in.
Do you just not pay attention to everybody else's desks?
Well, no wonder I'm not getting much done these days.
Coakley Brothers and Brothers Interiors, the official moving and furniture provider of GKB Milwaukee.
Wisconsin's own Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all. QC Kinetics announces the arrival of National Medical Director Dr. Mitchell Sheinkup, an acclaimed orthopedic surgeon with two decades of experience and extensive research in regenerative medicine.
But I was one of the first orthopedic surgeons to do it, and at the same time, I integrated clinical research that's resulted in several publications that are really directing the future of regenerative medicine. I was drawn to QC Kinetics after I reviewed their protocols, and everything they were doing is consistent with my own approach.
Today, Dr. Sheinkup leads the entire team of medical professionals at QC Kinetics, taking this exciting medical breakthrough to a whole new level.
What we are doing at QC Kinetics is transforming lives.
Get lasting joint pain relief. Call QC Kinetics now for your free consultation.
This is the future of medicine.
Call QC Kinetics, 414-285-3474. That's 414-285-3474. 414-285-3474.
When you're high, you feel different. Pretty obvious, right? You think different, talk different, but if you feel different, you drive different. So if you're high, just don't drive. Brought to you by NHTSA and the Ad Council.
You're listening to Wilde and Tausch on 94.5 ESPN. Presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin and sponsored by American Family Insurance.
Jesse and Tausch live from Buck and Honey's in Sun Prairie, awaiting the arrival of the Packers tailgate tour bus, which may or may not just come straight to them and hang out all day at Buck and Honey's.
I think they're roasting marshmallows right now.
I don't really like your attitude about this.
I think a little campfire, it's beautiful. You're playing Pictionary on one of those big whiteboards. Having a great time.
Is Pictionary a campfire game?
If it's not, it should be.
I thought maybe
no,
like
it
ladder
shouldn't.
Ball or
First of all, you don't have a flat surface to write on.
I mean, if you have a big tailgate bus, you can put
putting out an easel, though. He just said he's got an easel.
Then where's your campfire if you're talking like about this in a tailgate
You got like a big white grease board. You put it under the bus.
Murphy can't be good at Pictionary.
I think he'd be better at Pictionary than he would be like Taboo.
Nice. Not bad, actually. Tausch will continue to give us imaginary updates on the Packers tailgate tour bus that is
so
not parked outside.
The tailgate tour has been going, I think I did like the second one. I think the tailgate tour has been going now 20 some odd years. And the fact that Wilde had no concept of what was going on still is amazing to me.
It's cute. You can continue with that narrative. I actually do understand it. I just thought they spent more time in Sun Prairie today, which was part of the reasoning behind you guys being at Buck and Honey's. So I'm glad that they are spreading cheer and green and gold happiness throughout the state, including in Sun Prairie. Jesse, you mentioned it, but let's give this one more pop before we move on. Tonight's event in Sun Prairie is what?
It's at Angel Park, and it benefits Sunshine Place. So this is going to be where the real action is, not us sitting around here with imaginary updates. Later tonight is the big show. So that's at Angel Park. You're going to be there, right,
Tausch? I will be
there, you're going to
yes.
be part of this thing. And it supports Sunshine Place, which supports services for families and individuals facing food insecurity, housing instability, and other barriers to family and household stability. It's a really great cause. You can learn more at sunshineplace.org. To find out all the things that they do, but we'll give updates again throughout the course of the day. And, of course, tonight, everything benefiting Sunshine Place. And that's what's awesome about the tailgate tour, that all around the state benefits all these great different causes. And Sunshine Place and Sun Prairie, one of the many being supported by the Packers tailgate tour this year.
Tausch, do you have an actual, like, role in the event? Like, are you on stage? Are you going to... tell dad jokes?
Yeah, I got dad jokes in my pun book. I'm bringing my.
All right.
Wow. That'll really pack them in to Angel Park.
I'm not 100% sure how many puns I'm going to bring, but I will bring my pun book out to Angel Park tonight.
Can you pick your favorites and have Mark Murphy deliver them for everyone?
I don't know. I'm not sure where Mark's head's at.
Work together on that. I like
it. I think now that he's in front of, you know, I think he'll be more buttoned up. But, yeah, I'll see if he's open to doing something like that.
Well, it's a big couple of days for you because you not only will be part of tonight's events in Sun Prairie, but also you got mentioned in Rob Domofsky's story about Rasheed Walker.
Oh, wow.
As an example of a seventh-round pick who can become a stalwart offensive lineman and starting tackle for a very, very, very long time. Rasheed Walker was the 249th overall pick in 2022. Unlike Tausch, he did not start as a rookie. He played 4 special team snaps his rookie year, but last year he started 17 of the Packers' 19 games, including playoffs, and it led to a reference about Old T.
I don't think I realized he started that many games. I suppose David played 1. I just
Yash
thought
started
Yash
1.
Him. Yeah, that's
and that was it.
Interesting tidbit by Rob. That's a lot of starts.
Yeah, that was my tidbit. But be that as it may, here's the part from Rob. The Packers have turned seventh-round picks like Walker into long-term starting linemen before. Mark Tauscher, a seventh-rounder in 2000, went on to start 132 games at right tackle over his 11-year career. Mm. Now, you did experience toward the end of your career, not early, I don't think. Maybe when they picked in the 4th round Alan Barber. But were you apprehensive every year around this time that they might take a tackle high in the draft and how that might affect your future?
No.
Because you can't live that way or because you knew you were the dude?
No, I mean, you can always, for me, it just didn't matter because I knew every year stood on its own and you had to go out and deliver. So, obviously, I didn't want them to take a tackle in the first round, you know, in 2003, 4, 5, like that, mm-hmm. because you understand the economics and the business of football that they're going to want their first round pick or second round pick to play. But they also, from a coaching staff standpoint, want to win. And if you're doing your thing and you're doing what you're supposed to do and you're doing it consistently and the coaches trust you, nothing to worry about. So there's so many other things you can worry about. And what good is it going to do for me back then, Rasheed Walker, to sit there and pout and whine and cry and mope and sulk?
Uh-huh.
If they draft somebody at the 25th pick, is that going to help him accomplish what he's looking for? Or is it going to put a spur in his boot, a craw in his daddy? I don't know, whatever other saying you want to say.
Say,
you know what? Let's let this thing go.
You should use that on stage tonight.
You focus and you let it rip and you try to figure out a way to continue to hold on to that job because – I don't care if they draft a kid number one, he is not going to be the starting left tackle going into training camp. Rasheed Walker is going to get that opportunity. And just like we heard Steno last year, Yash Nyman should have been able to secure that and run with it. He didn't. And part of that is credit to Rasheed Walker that he hung in and did what his deal was. So you're always in competition. Unless you're the highest paid, best player in the world, you're going to be in competition, and everybody knows they're drafting someone. They want to get younger and cheaper every year and better. And it's your job to not let them do it.
That was really good, except for the craw in your daddy.
Craw in your daddy?
So
you know what I meant.
So Rob and I and Wes Hodkowitz and a few others talked to Rasheed Walker before they departed on their tailgate tour. And we talked to him about this very topic. And we had Matt Bowen on yesterday, who said that Amarius Mims, the Georgia tackle, would be the kind of guy that you don't necessarily want him to start right away as a rookie. He started 8 games at Georgia. Packers had him in on a top 30 visit. So maybe there is this half measure where Rashid Walker is the starter for another year and Mims moves into the starting lineup down the road as a first-round pick. But you're right. It doesn't do you any good to mope.
So, Jason, here's the deal. This is the fascinating part, and this is why late-round picks constantly have a chip on their shoulder. Because if Rashid Walker was a second or third round pick, we wouldn't even have this conversation.
You're right. You're right.
But you know totally. What? What was Zach Tom? What was he picked?
5th.
And nobody's having that conversation. I don't care. They could draft Orlando Pace Jr. and say he's going to be our right tackle. Zach Tom ain't giving that spot up. And there ain't anybody that doubts that. The fact that he's played at that level. So if Rashid Walker goes out and plays the first half of next season and is a stud, he'll be Zach Tom'd, and we'll be stop having that conversation.
Zach Tom, a 4th-round pick, I should correct. He was the 140th overall pick, so he went 109 picks before Rashid Walker.
So this is why draft picks matter, because the old saying and the adage about late picks have to constantly prove themselves for early picks have to constantly prove that they can't, but you can do it. And you can prove it. And if Rashid Walker showcases that he is as good as he finished the season off and he plays well, none of this other stuff matters.
But you would agree that Zach Tom has played at a higher level than Rashid Walker did 100%. And done it for longer.
Yes.
And that's why we're not talking about
him. I literally just said that. And that's why nobody is saying, well, they draft this kid from Georgia. He's played right tackle. Oh, okay, great. Zach Tom's going to play where he wants. Because Zach Tom's a stud. Nobody's saying that about Sheed yet because he has not proven it over a long haul. And I think there's doubts. Oh, he's a 7th-round pick. Is he a fast enough feet? Oh, can he hold up, you know, against the best? You know, those are the questions he's going to keep getting. And when and if they draft a offensive tackle, the Georgia kid or whoever it would be, everybody is just going to assume, oh, he's going to take your spot. You know who's got control on it? Rashid Walker and say, no, he's not. He's not going to. Because he's proven he can block in his league. This young kid, he hadn't proven that yet. He's got all the skills and the talent, but that don't mean jack. I've seen plenty of first-round, second-round picks can't play a lick. Oh, they got great numbers. They move. Yeah, that's great. How are you going to handle when you get beat and it's loud? Are you going to say, are you going to bow up? I don't know. That's when you find out what you got. And Rashid Walker is able to bounce back and do that last year. I don't know if this new kid, that's the part that you can't test, that you see, you watch, and you understand it.
There's also the possibility that they feel good enough about him that they will not go tackle in the first round at all anyway. And
I'm telling you, in an ideal world, they want to get an interior lineman, a.k.a. I believe they want to have somebody that can be the starting center. I don't think they want to pay Josh Myers $12 million a year to be their starting center moving forward. I think they want to refurbish, get younger, and have another stud inside. That's what I think they want to do with that with one of those early picks.
The conversation we'll have with Rob Domofsky, who had some interesting statistics in his ESPN.com story, is Rashid Walker good enough that they don't have to draft a tackle? Because Matt LaFleur's answer initially at the NFL meetings was kind of wishy-washy. Then it was stronger, but he also pointed out that we'd seen great flashes, but not consistency from Rashid Walker. He also, as we all did, talked to Brian Bulaga about Rashid Walker, who, as we know on this show, watches film of every game very closely and had seen the improvement in Rashid Walker. We'll talk about that with Rob. He's scheduled to appear next. I also do wonder, and we can get to this with you later, but did you ever reach the point where you didn't feel like you had a worry?
Like, if you get to that point, you're in trouble.
Like, is that, because that's not necessarily complacency, right? Like, Jordan Love's not worried about Sean Clifford taking his job now. He's focused on being the best version of himself, but like, Does the chip ever go away? We'll talk about that as well. Rob, scheduled to appear coming up. Want to remind you that right now is the best time to refresh your space during Steinhoffel's three-day best brand sale. You can take an extra 10% off all of their best brands, Cannadel, Gasho, King Hickory, Flex Steel, and more, all 10% off. And if you need a little extra help transforming your space, save up to $200 on Steinhoffel's design services. Plus, you'll get a $100 Bucks gift card when you spend over $1,999. Today through Sunday only, you can shop both in-store and online at steinhoffels.com. Rob Domofsky scheduled to appear next. It's Wilde and Tausch.
On air, online, and on demand. Get all your favorite ESPN Wisconsin content anywhere you get your podcasts for free. The new Wisconsin On Demand. It's free, it's everywhere, and it's for you.
The Bucks are back on broadcast TV. Tonight, watch the Milwaukee Bucks on WMLW-VM. And you don't need a streaming service to see this matchup. Just tune in to WMLW-VM starting at 6:30 on over-the-air channel 49. Also on Spectrum, DirecTV, Dish, and others. The Bucks back on broadcast TV. Tonight versus the Thunder on WMLW-VM starting at 6:30. Visit WMLW.com for everything Bucks.
Discover the difference at findhigherlove.com/CBD. Higher Love Cannabis Company is the only cultivator in the UP offering organic, clean, green certified products. That means quality you can trust every time. With 7 locations across the UP, including Menominee, Norway, and Ironwood, finding your Higher Love is easier than ever before. And for our friends in Green Bay, Higher Love is less than an hour away. Kindness starts with you. Experience Higher Love today. Visit findhigherlove.com/CBD and follow them on social media at findhigherlove.
Are you ready to start a meaningful career in healthcare? Are you looking for a job that fits your work-life balance? Become a certified direct care professional today and make life better for older adults or people with a disability. WISC Caregiver Careers makes it easy with free online training plus earn a $500 bonus. See your name on Wisconsin's Certified Direct Care Registry. Sign up today at WISCCaregiverCDCP.com. Sponsored by the Wisconsin Department of Health Services.
It's ESPN Wisconsin's Brad Dortmund. NBA fans, listen up. You've got to try Pick 6, the newest fantasy app from DraftKings, an official partner of the NBA. Getting started is simple. Select if a player will have more or less of a certain stat. For example, will a player have more than one rebound? Or will a player have less than 3.5 assists? Pick your favorite players and compete for huge cash prizes. Download the new DraftKings Pick 6 app now using code WKTI and take on the competition with your best NBA player picks. Only on DraftKings. Pick 6 with code WKTI. The crown is yours. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER. 18 plus in most eligible states. Age varies by jurisdiction. Eligibility restrictions apply. Pick 6 not available in all states. For up-to-date list of states, visit dkng.co/pick6states. Void where prohibited. See terms at pick6.draftkings.com/promos.
ESPN Milwaukee Cares is here. Gabe Neitzel is teaming up with the MAC Fund to raise funds and awareness for pediatric cancer research. Here's Gabe Neitzel to tell us more.
The MAC Fund has been fighting the fight against childhood cancer for the past 46 years, and all of their proceeds go directly to fund research for pediatric cancer. Director of Development Mike Bolowski draws inspiration from the families who have to fight this fight when he knows it's time to do his job.
I look at them and I think, you guys have to be the toughest people in the world. And they all say the same thing. They say, well, we have no other choice. But it's not like, life for these folks every day is so much different than the rest of us. And they put their head down, and we're fortunate that, at the MAC Fund, we have some great medical partners, Children's Medical College, UW Carbone Cancer Center, that these are extremely brilliant minds trying to help these kids.
To learn more and to donate, text CARES to 800-990-3776.
Beautify your entertainment space with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Hi, this is Gina Della from Pella. Turn your ordinary space into something extraordinary with brand new Pella windows. Plus, getting the perfect windows and doors for your home has never been easier. Right now, get 0% interest for up to 36 months, or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th. Take ownership of your living space and make it a place worth living with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
This is Wilde and Tausch on 94.5 ESPN, sponsored by American Family Insurance. Insure carefully, dream fearlessly. Get a quote and find an agent at amfam.com.
Rob Domofsky is not on the tailgate or bus.
No. I think he's out there roasting a hot dog with Murph.
Oh, my God.
But I'm sure he had a better understanding of what
Rob's
today would look
Dijon
like.
I bet Rob's a Dijon guy, isn't he? He likes a little Dijon mustard.
Bijan Robinson?
I like Dijon.
Mm. And Bijan. Well, we like Rob Domofsky, and we like the fact that he snuck your name into his story at ESPN.com.
I'd like him to promote the show when he does that in his article. I don't know if that's IPT or not, but that's what I would prefer.
How does it feel that you've gotten in his head enough where he went from thinking about you with the articles to just writing about you?
Flat out mentioning you, yeah.
You know, Rob's my, I think he might be my favorite now.
Well, bad news for Tom Silverstein. It is Rob Domofsky from ESPN.com. Rob, good morning. How are you?
I'm good, guys. How are you?
We're great. So the Rasheed Walker story to me is a very interesting one, and I thought you had some fascinating statistics that would indicate that maybe he's better than he got credit for last season. Tell us about those numbers that you included along with Tausch's name in your piece at ESPN.com.
Yeah, my bad for not mentioning the show. That was I don't know if that would have made it through the editors. What I should have said was I put it in there and the editors took it out. That's what I should have said.
I appreciate
it. But you're too honest.
Yeah,
you're honest to a fault.
Thank you for your efforts, Rob.
So Rasheed Walker, we all thought, you know, had an okay first year as a starter at left tackle, but there were, you know, some inconsistencies. But there's two things that I think, A, support that, but B, give you, you know, maybe pause to think that they don't have to draft a tackle in the first round or even the second round. He did allow 8 sacks, which was the most among any Packers lineman, and was probably, there were probably maybe, I want to say 15 or 20 guys in the league that allowed more than 8 sacks. However, according to ESPN's pass block win rate, which I believe is essentially they watch every play, and if you hold your block for more than 2.5 seconds and in that time the quarterback is unaffected by it, then you get a win. And he had literally the highest pass block win rate of any offensive lineman, regardless of position, tackle, guard, center, that played at least 450 snaps last season.
In the whole league?
That's number one in the whole league.
That's pretty good. Wow.
Now, his run blocking was about middle of the pack, I think was 37th out of 70 tackles.
Rob, Wilde, you guys remember what Josh Sitton said, right?
About wiping his rear end with his
Not the butt wiping.
I got higher grades from the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel because I was a source.
Oh, wow. You're going to throw that out there, huh?
Wow. He said many things, Tausch, as we have illustrated.
It basically was your pass block for dough.
Yeah. Yeah, and that's, you know, he's probably – one of the things he's probably not wrong about was that.
I can't believe we'll be throwing a shot at him like that. Wow.
Yeah. I do think, though, that, like, it makes you think, well, you know, maybe tackle isn't the – absolute surefire, you know, pick at 25 or what's the next one? 50 something? 51?
No, 41 and then 58.
So 41. Yeah, that's right. 41. You know, maybe it's not. Maybe they aren't taking a tackle. And maybe they do believe in Rasheed Walker. Now, Matt LaFleur's comment about, you know, he was our tackle this year when asked whether he's the tackle of the future. So, and then he quickly kind of changed course and praised them a little bit. But, of course, our friend Wes just heard the praise. But the That was an inside joke.
But anyway, I appreciate it.
But yeah, I mean, it is. I think, you know, here, if you're Rashid Walker, and this is basically what I said in the lead of the story, you have literally no idea whether you're the left tackle for the next, you know, 6-7 years, or you're out of a job if they draft somebody, and that's the crazy thing about this game.
Wow,
is that, you know, you can think that, you know, you have a job, and then all of a sudden, based on the draft, you don't.
No, I mean, he's not going to be out of a job. He's going to be the swing tackle if he doesn't.
Well, right,
out of a starting job.
I think it's. I mean, there is no question they're going to try and upgrade that spot. I don't think anybody, you can read the tea leaves. That's going to be something, but it's going to be up to Rashid to utilize some of that positive stuff. Yeah, he's got some negative things too, and see how he progresses. But Rob, I really think that they want to find the center of the future. Do you think, if you had a guess right now at this time, is Josh Myers on this team after, when we're looking at, what is it, April 13th today? Is he on this team next year?
No. In fact, I think the starting center is on this team right now, but it's not Josh Myers, the long-term starting center.
Who's it going to be?
I was told by a couple people
this juicy?
That within the organization, they think Zach Tom is a really good – is a Pro Bowl right tackle, an all-pro guard, and a potential Hall of Fame center.
Ooh.
So there's your set. There's your center.
Wow.
In my
Man, it is nice when beat guys bring takes like that. Holy
cats. That's a direct quote from
that is take. That's him quoting someone in the building.
Wow.
Yeah, that is not. That's called reporting. That's not bold predicting.
Jason, did you hear that?
I did. In fact, I've heard that from Rob multiple times.
Yeah, Rob, you're my number one. Hey, Rob, you are my number one. Holy cats. So you're telling me somebody in that front office told you, because I was just saying, Zach Tom gonna have to worry. They draft a tackle. You don't have to worry. He's going to be, you know, if he wants to be the tackle, he's going to be the tackle.
Yeah, that's one of the benefits of going to the combine and being out late at night and running into people in the building.
What a bold and sexy take that was. Hall of Fame center is what you're telling me. Dwight Stevenson.
Wow.
Dermoni Dawson. Zach Tom.
Well, we'll see.
Wow. That just blew my mind.
Like, are you so blown away you have no more questions? Or?
Yeah, go ahead. I'm shocked.
While I'm just thinking of the next question, I will say that you talked about the Dijon mustard. Jason knows this. I am not a condiment guy. We've talked about this when you've been out on assignment, that I no ketchup, no mustard, no mayo for me.
So your fries are just straight-up fries, or you don't eat fries?
I love cheese fries.
Cheese
I
fries.
Love cheese
but
fries.
You dip in nothing. You don't like an aioli? You don't like
I will eat an aioli or a chipotle mayo or flavored mayo, but straight up mayo on a sandwich, no thanks.
So ketchup for nothing, huh? You don't want ketchup on anything?
Ketchup is the A number one, as Mike McCarthy would say, A number one bad thing. And in fact, I've said this before, there are many things, I'll just say it. I would rather eat a steaming pile of dog doo-doo than ketchup.
You would not.
Well, no, I know. I'm exaggerating, but...
That was a bold, sexy take right there, too.
At this point, Rob can say whatever else he wants, and he's
got a few gimmies.
He gave us exactly what I was looking for. Good, yeah. He could say that he'd rather eat bird poop than ketchup, and we'd be like, okay, Rob, yep, that sounds good.
Talking with Rob Dabowski from ESPN.com. Rob, did you know that the do you know a lot about the tailgate tour? You've never been on it, right? Aaron Popke has never gotten you on the bus.
No, I'm not big on bus trips. But what I know about the tailgate tour, what I know about the tailgate tour comes from standing outside the American Family Insurance gate at 8 a.m. before they leave and interviewing the participants. Most years, that's as far as I go with the tailgate tour. I've never been to one of the stops.
So that's exactly what we did earlier this week, and during that time, you got to reconnect with Alex Green, who was very excited to see you. I thought that
was
great.
Yeah, Dude, I don't even remember ever interviewing him when he was sincere, but he was very. That told me how good I looked and that I haven't aged at all. So.
What the hell is another
one? Thought I was somebody else.
Another bold and sexy take. But the one thing I'm curious about before you go is that when we go back to the offensive line, we had Elgton Jenkins there, we had Bulaga there, obviously Rashid Walker. It is in a weird spot, right? We just got done talking about what we think of the center position. And yet, in theory, depending on how the draft falls, the five that are theoretically starting could be very well opening the season in Brazil as the starting five. Like, it's not like it's this massive glaring need, even though they moved on from a five-time All-Pro and let two other guys who started a fair number of games move on. What do you make of where they're at on the line as a whole?
Well, clearly they were planning for that, Jason, with the rotation between Runyon and Sean Ryan, right? I mean, that was when you knew John Runyon wasn't coming back, so they were already sort of preparing for that. And while Sean Ryan didn't start, he played, and you could almost say, well, he's a returning player at that position. It's not, I mean, it is a new starter, but it's not a new starter, if that makes sense. And then, you know, if Rashid ends up holding the job down, you're right. But it's like the only position on offense, maybe other than one more tight end, but it would be more of a specialty blocking type of tight end. But those are really the only spots on offense where you're like, okay, there might be a little bit of a question mark. They, you know, they don't need, they're set at receiver. You know, running backs one and two appear to be set. Now, that doesn't mean they won't draft somebody in the third, fourth, fifth round, somewhere like that. But otherwise, you know, we've seen this before, but otherwise I think it's going to be a defensive draft, which, you know, shocking because they seem like they're all defensive drafts around here. But, look, the thing, the improvement for this team on offense is probably not going to come from new starters or new players other than Josh Jacobs, obviously. But it's going to come from how much the first and second year players from last year improved, you know, to this year. And that's where this team gets better, and that includes the quarterback as well.
All right, Rob, last thing before we let you go and we talk to Rashid Walker coming up. Are you going to Brazil? Are you excited to go to Brazil? And are you commuting to fly out of Chicago because of those darn runways that just aren't long enough up here in Green Bay?
I don't know for sure if I'm going, but if I'm going, I will be flying out of Green Bay because I will not be on the direct flight. There's last time I checked on Expedia, there was no direct. So I did look on the preferred airline website. It starts with V and ends with A and has a ELTA in the middle. Is the preferred airline of Rob Domofsky Travel and Leisure.
So you'll promote Delta Airlines, but you won't promote Will Detosh. Okay.
Wow.
What else can we promote,
this has been
Rob?
Quite a roller coaster.
Rob, what's your drink of choice that you ought to promote? Like, where's your favorite restaurant and everything else?
At this point, Tosh, Delta has given me more than the William Tausch show. More upgrades.
Dang. I find that.
I don't even have a Wilde and Tausch like coffee mug or T-shirt or anything.
Neither do we.
Yeah, that's true.
It was $2,200 on the flight there, and I have sent my submit. My boss has asked me to send an estimated cost. And I sent them the estimated cost, and they're going to see whether they want to send one of us, meaning either me or our Eagles reporter, which is typically what they do on international games. They only send one of the two reporters. But this case, they said they were going to look into sending both of us. Apparently, you need a visa. Not only do you need a passport, but you need a visa to go over.
I thought
over
I saw someone sent me something. You don't need a visa till after that game. It'll be the next year.
Okay.
But I don't know, Rob. If if you had to choose,
if you listen to Tausch, you might not get to go.
Do you want to go?
I want to go because it's probably a place I would never go on my own. I wouldn't just say, "Yeah, let's go to Brazil." So from that standpoint, I would. I don't. The part that gives me pause is that it's the first game over there, and do they have the kinks ironed out? I mean, look, the London game was pretty cool to go to London. But from a logistic standpoint, getting places, getting to the stadium, getting to the practice, It was a nightmare. It took forever. And they've been doing it in London for how many years? And it was still, maybe that's London and the traffic, but I would rather go if it was the second time that they were in Brazil. The first one I think is going to be, you know, there's going to be a lot of things that they haven't thought of, and it might be a difficult trip. But no, you know what, if they're playing a game, I would rather cover it in person than not cover it in person.
Mm-hmm. There you go.
Rob, we appreciate you, buddy. Thanks.
All right, have a great weekend. We'll be seeing you.
That is Rob Domofsky from ESPN.com.
He brought that smoke.
Yeah, well, apparently we need to get him a mug.
I was just trying to think, like, is Delta paying him to come on their airlines? I doubt it. Maybe I'm wrong.
But at least we know how he would get to, say, Detroit if he wanted to go to the draft, because he is not going to get to go as part of AmFam's promotion.
No, calling all Packer fans, American Family Insurance wants to see you and a friend in Detroit for this year's draft. Enter the Dream Draft Day sweepstakes for the chance to win two tickets to the draft, travel and hotel accommodations to Detroit, customizable jersey, and much, much more. Go to AmFam.com/Packers to learn more and to enter.
More next. It's Wildy and Tausch.
Wildy and Tausch continues next on 94.5 ESPN, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin and sponsored by American Family Insurance. In season, off season, draft season, whatever season it is, we are Milwaukee's place to talk green and gold. Listen, watch, or stream live whenever, wherever. 94.5 ESPN.
What is dedication?
People ask, how your children learn how to ride a bike and you didn't. I just created an environment where they taught themselves and all I had to do was be there.
That's dedication. Visit fatherhood.gov to hear more. Brought to you by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services and the Ad Council.
Hi, it's John Reitz from Great Midwest Bank. And you know, there's more to being a local Wisconsin bank than perfectly pronouncing Oconomowoc or Waukesha. Or is it Waukesha? But rest assured, at Great Midwest Bank, we understand the local community and economy because we're a part of it. At GMB, we provide customized lending products that others just can't offer. Experience a hometown banking difference. Head to greatmidwestbank.com. Great Midwest Bank, your simply local equal housing lender.
Call Wisconsin's own Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all.
Your bathroom is boring and basic too. It seems like there's nothing you can do. A better bath awaits. You'll feel brand new. Relaxing in a world of peace at the Bath Authority.
Hey, it's Kyle Wallace. Right now, schedule your free in-home estimate and get $1,000 off a new shower or bath, plus 36 months of interest-free financing. Restrictions apply. A better bath awaits.
You're our priority at the Bath Authority.
Nelnet Incorporated, the nation's largest, most respected student loan servicer, has document imaging technology from James Imaging Systems. Facilities coordinator, Sunday Heideman.
James Imaging has been a local provider for us for many years. They are reliable, they're responsible, and they take care of all of our printer needs.
Just what you'd expect from a 100% Wisconsin-owned and managed business technology company.
I think we get a great value with James Imaging, with their service and the contracts that we have with them, that our cost stays low and we get the most for our money.
Sunday, what's the benefit for you with James Imaging Systems?
It makes my job more enjoyable that I can count on these people to do what they're trained to do, and I have no worries because I know I'm going to be taken care of.
James Imaging Systems. Call 262-781-7700. James Imaging Systems, your local business technology partner.
You ever have one of those days when you just couldn't come up with the right answer? Well, I know one answer that pretty much solves all problems. Ice cream. Yeah, it's the answer to everything, right? And right now, at Quick Trip, our rich, creamy, straight from our dairy, Nature's Touch, 1 gallon pails of ice cream are just $4.99. Yeah, now that's an answer worth digging into. Come on, be a problem solver. Bring home some fresh, delicious Nature's Touch ice cream, only from Quick Trip.
The biggest names in the basketball world.
Dame Dollar.
Lillard.
Having fun and honest conversations.
He puts it in the shoe, right? And sets the tone for brothers and sisters and family.
Every week, Thanasis Adetokounmpo sits down with special guests on the Analysis Show. Presented by Potawatomi Casino Hotel and Curbless Ready to Drink Cocktails.
Fantastic.
Find the Analysis Show on Spotify, Apple, or wherever you get your podcasts. And on YouTube by searching the Analysis Show.
Station updates, show clips, and your place to interact with us every single day just by scrolling through your feed. Follow along on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram at ESPN Milwaukee. You're listening to Wildy and Tausch on 94.5 ESPN. Missed any of the show? Find us on Wisconsin On Demand wherever you get your podcasts. It's free, it's everywhere, and it's for you.
Thanks to Rob Domofsky for telling us that he'd rather eat dog poop than ketchup, but also for telling us that Zach Tom could be a Pro Football Hall of Fame center in the estimation of some that work inside the building at Lambeau Field.
It's really tough to see somebody that plays the offensive tackle position as well as he does and move him into center. It's a big, bold move, man. That's one of those things. Now, if you draft that tackle, that's why if you're Rashid Walker, you just keep plugging, because maybe what might happen next year, you put Zach Tom in. You know, there's a lot of moving pieces with that whole deal.
Indeed, there is. Zach Tom will be playing in this league regardless. I think he's proven that. He will not be joining the Johnson & Sons paving team like you will be, at least albeit briefly, for one gig.
Indeed. And who wants a visit with old T? Well, if you are, Johnson & Sons is inviting me out to one of their job sites this summer. And that could be with your business. Book an appointment before May 31st, and you could see me out there with the crew. Got all the gear they've sent me. I got the level. I got a hard hat. I got a vest. I got a sweater. All out there. And I'll be ready to get out there and work. And you know, the winter here in Wisconsin, it is pothole country, potholes everywhere. I hope that's what old T's going to end up be doing. I'm going to come out there and I'm going to get some of that good asphalt. We're going to get that nice leveled out so your roads are beautiful that you can drive on. That's what old T's going to get done. It'll be nice, easy work for the Tauschenator. Visit Johnson & Sons.
What?
What? That's what happens when you ad-lib a little too much. Visit JohnsonAndSonsPaving.com, and I'll start digging for my heart.
Why'd you end up in the UP?
Well, I'm trying to follow that tailgate tour. I think they might be up there.
Rashid Walker scheduled to join Jesse, myself, and the Tauschenator to kick off the 10 o'clock.
The Tauschenator, eh?
Oh, jeez, the Tauschenator.
Laying that asphalt, huh?
Yeah, it was something. Not sure where that came from.
We'll introduce.
It's not a woof, Riley.
We'll introduce Tausch to Rashid Walker. Next, it's Wildy and Tausch.
Don't go anywhere. Another hour of Wildy and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin, is coming up next on ESPN Wisconsin, the ESPN app, and Wisconsin On Demand.
A season of award-winning golf at Sweetgrass and Sage Run is on the horizon. The Island Resort and Casino stay-and-play golf packages are booking fast, with choice dates available early in the week. After your rounds, visit the Drift Spa for a relaxing or targeted massage session. And enjoy dinner at Horizon's scenic top-floor steakhouse. So many reasons to take a drive. Book your stay-and-play golf package today. Visit islandresortgolf.com.
Get the beat of the Bucks straight from a fan favorite and Bucks legend. Tap into Hear District with Marcus Johnson, a Bucks Plus audio production. Your weekly pulse on the Milwaukee Bucks and conversations with the biggest names in basketball. This week, Marcus and his son Chris are joined by ESPN NBA writer Tim Bontemps.
Find your district now on Bucks.com/plus, the Bucks app, or wherever you get your podcast.
It's time for the Milwaukee Basketball Report on 94.5 ESPN. Brought to you by Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin. Experience elite orthopedic care at OAW. Their skilled teams in Pewaukee, Brookfield, and Mukwonago offer tailored treatment for your needs.
The Milwaukee Bucks made it two wins in a row last night at Fiserv Forum, defeating the Orlando Magic 117-99. Bobby Portis Little scores with 30 points, shooting 14 of 18 from the floor in the first game without Giannis Antetokounmpo. Despite the injury scare earlier this week, Doc thinks the vibe might be changing for the team.
Wins help, you know that, like in life or anything. And last night's game was probably the reason we won tonight, you know, and that's a good thing.
And the Bucks are currently the 2 seed in the playoffs with a 1.5 game lead over the New York Knicks.
This has been the Milwaukee Basketball Report on 94.5 ESPN, brought to you by Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin. Book your appointment today at orthowisconsin.com.
Tune in to KBN every day at 2 o'clock. Kyle, Bruston, Nortman. 94.5 ESPN is WKTI and WKTI HD, Milwaukee.
A locally owned Good Karma brand station.
The 10 o'clock hour of Wilde and Tausch begins now, and it begins not with more Mark Tauscher, who just called himself the Tauschinator, but a player who has drawn some comparisons to Tausch, at least in Rob Domofsky's story at ESPN.com. He is the Packers' starting left tackle. He is on the tailgate tour. He may be on the bus. Apparently, I don't understand how the tailgate tour works, so we'll have to ask him how it's working for him today. It is Rasheed Walker on Wilde and Tausch. Rasheed, how are you, man?
How you doing? I'm doing good. Yeah, we are on the bus.
Now, there has been some reports that Bulaga, who is a good friend of ours and who I covered for a long time, was going to do this appearance, and then it was going to be Kenny. And how did you end up with the short end of the phone stick and you got stuck with us?
I'm the youngest person on the bus. So everybody just, you know, figured, yeah, she got the...
That's typically how that works, yeah.
Well, you know, on the bright side, I get to talk to y'all, so I'm not mad at it.
Oh, look at you. What a veteran play there, Rasheed. I know you're still a young player, but that was a veteran deal. So, Rasheed, how has the whole offseason been for you so far? You obviously finished the season strong. Give us a little taste into what your offseason's been like.
For this offseason, after the last game of the season, I hung out in Green Bay for about like a week and a half. And then I took a little vacation to Mexico. And then shortly after that, I got right back to work. You know, we report to OTAs next week, so I had to make sure. My whole thing, I just wanted to make sure I was in shape and I didn't miss a beat when we got back to work. So, you know, I've been working out, hanging out, and then I was honored to be invited to the tailgate tour. It's my first tour. My first time doing a tour, and I've been having a blast. We've met thousands of fans, you know, talked to a bunch of kids in a bunch of different schools. It's just been making it.
We lose him?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no, there he is.
Losing signal on the bus.
Well, that bus is moving. Jason thought the bus was just sitting there. Rasheed, who's the funniest person on the tailgate tour?
I have to say Mike Daniels. Mike Daniels has been keeping he's been keeping everybody entertained. I'm pretty sure y'all know about Mike. Yeah, he's been keeping everybody entertained for sure.
That answer did not surprise me at all. Rasheed, going back to your workouts for the offseason, when Domofsky and I and Wes were talking to you earlier in the week before the bus tour left, you talked about how your workouts, you've tried to make them more game-like to get you ready for playing time. What is that? We didn't get to follow up because you guys had to get on the bus. What does that mean? How have you altered your workouts to try and be more game-like?
Everything I do, I've been working on my functional movements a lot. You know, I've been doing, like, a lot of isolated weightlifting, you know, because I use independent hands when I'm, you know, doing my passes. So, you know, I've been doing much like independent dumbbell work, resistance, a lot of footwork drills. You know, I've been doing a lot, like a lot of punching drills, like burn. Just doing things to keep that muscle memory. So, you know, deep in the season, you know, when I'm tired, I can just fall back on my training.
So, Rashid, we were teasing Rob Domofsky from ESPN earlier. He joined us before you did, because in his story about you at ESPN.com, he references Tausch, who played 11 years in the NFL, started 132 games, was a seventh-round pick like you from a Big Ten school from Wisconsin. And I'm just wondering, as we, because we all asked you about this before you guys left, but how are you handling the uncertainty of whether or not they might draft a tackle high, maybe they don't? How confident are you that no matter what happens, you've proven yourself in this league?
You know, with that, I just try to, you know, worry about things that I can't control. You know, I just stay confident in what I can do. Like, I know I'm a great player. You know, I know what I'm going to bring to the field every time I step on the field. I'm going to do my job. So, you know, as far as, like, the draft, like, I don't got nothing to do with me, really. I can't really control it, so I don't really think about it much. You know, regardless of what happens, I'm going to come in with my head down and work. You know, I'm going to try to contribute to the team. But I do feel like I'm the man for the job.
Rashid, when you look back at how last season played out, was there a moment, and you know, I ask a lot of guys this question, when you knew you belonged? Because I think everybody, especially late picks, you know, we all work hard and we want, but then you have that moment, whether it was in practice or in a game, where you were like, yeah, I know I can do this.
Oh, I always knew it. There was never a doubt. I always knew that I could do it. You know, I would say, like, early in my career, I didn't realize how intense, like, being in the actual NFL football game was. You know, it's a little bit different than college and high school. Everything's a little bit more faster. You know, you can't take any false steps. You can't miss a beat or you want to blow the play, especially when I'm in the line. Because once I got settled in, I think my – one of the plays where I, you know, came to the conclusion that, you know, I was where I was supposed to be when I think it was when we played with the Rams, and it was like a dance. You know, ball, one of the linebackers going to the ground. I was like, yeah, that was easy. So that kind of, you know, gave me more confidence just to know, like, boom, if I just play fast and free, then I can do it. So.
Talking with Rashid Walker on Wilde and Tausch. He is on the tailgate tour bus as it makes its way to Sun Prairie, where Tausch and Jesse are eagerly awaiting its arrival.
You think Balaga's making him get, like, coffee and stuff because Rashid's the young guy? He makes him come on our show. Is Balaga forcing you to, like, go get him food, and like, or has he been a pretty good dude so far?
Yeah, everybody's been pretty cool. We've been so busy, like, I think we're making about 4 or 5 stops a day. Oh, yeah. Nobody has any time to, you know, do any of that.
So, Rashid, a couple more things, and then we'll let you go. First of all, do you know who Mark Tauscher is that you're talking to? Like, I know you know who I am because I bother you at your locker on a regular basis. But are you familiar with Tausch's resume?
No, I need to do my homework on that. What's up with the resume?
Well, he set a hell of a standard as a right tackle for 11 years with that team. All right, I wanted to get to one other thing with you, and that is you have exuded confidence when we talked to you earlier in the week and when we talked to you now, and I don't think people understand, because you're a seventh-round pick, and you and I talked about this during the season, you know, you were a 4-star recruit. You had Ohio State recruiting you. You chose Penn State. Like, you played a hell of a lot of games with Sean Clifford with the Nittany Lions. Is confidence a crucial part of handling whatever the challenge will be this season, whether it's competition with a draft pick or just being the starting left tackle? Is that an important part of your game?
Yeah, I feel like you have to be confident. Once you do, you have to be confident that you have to play fast. And, you know, that all really comes with preparation. So, you know, that's something that I had to learn, like, throughout my training last season. Like, it's all about how you prepare, because, you know, whoever's prepared the best has a better chance of, you know, winning. So, you know, that all kind of ties together, like, confidence, preparation. Like, if you're not prepared to do your job, you probably won't be that confident, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So everything kind of just ties together.
All right, Sheed, I look forward to seeing you at the off-season program. Don't let Bulaga give you a hard time, and we appreciate your time, buddy. Thanks. That is Rashid Walker live from the Packers tailgate tour. I love the fact that he, Tausch, and again, I know that this is an important part of the game, and I'm sure you had guys that you played with or saw who didn't have that confidence level, and you saw what it did to them. But he authentically does not seem fazed by whatever it's going to be, whether he's going to be the starting left tackle or whether he's going to be competing with some high draft pick. He does have a lot of confidence.
He seems to have the right attitude, and again, he has proven that he can play. So now I think he realizes that they're going to probably bring somebody in. We'll see if he's up to the task to hold that, whoever that guy that comes in is going to be.
So from what you saw from him last season, and Brian and you and I talked about him multiple times late in the year, if he's the starting left tackle, are the Packers fine?
Yeah.
I agree.
They'll be fine.
Yeah, I think so too.
But I thought they'd be fine if they played Yosh Nijman too last year.
Yeah, that's fair. All right, well, the tailgate tour rolls on. They are on the move, as we noticed as he went in and out on his call. Surprised that Mike Daniels is keeping everyone entertained?
Oh, no, Mike is an incredibly entertaining dude. I kind of assumed that was what that answer was going to look like.
You never overlapped with him as a player, though, right?
I did not.
I think he was drafted a year or two after you had departed, but he's certainly always been entertaining when he's joined us. So the tailgate tour, again, is making its way to Sun Prairie. It will be there later today at Angel Park. Jesse,
mm-hmm.
And
that
again, tell us more about what the good works are that they're going to be doing while they're there.
Yeah, the tailgate tour stop in Sun Prairie today benefits Sunshine Place, which is an awesome organization right here in Sun Prairie, helping out a bunch of people. You can learn more at sunshineplace.org. It supports services for families and individuals facing food insecurity, housing instability, and other barriers to family and household stability. 1 in 14 adults and 1 in 9 children goes hungry in Wisconsin. So Sunshine Place strives to enhance the health of our neighbors in need with supplemental food and meals, among many other causes. Again, you can learn all kinds of details about how you can get involved. Sunshineplace.org is where you can find all the information and support the cause.
Jesse and Tausch are live from Buck and Honey's in Sun Prairie. Want to remind you, before we move on with this fine program, that Fleet Farm's Fleet Rewards program gives you the chance to earn rewards on your purchases. I'm earning rewards left and right. I got another $5 in Fleet Bucks that I'm going to use later today. You can join today for free and start earning those same rewards towards your next $5 reward in Fleet Bucks. Visit fleetfarm.com/rewards to join Fleet Rewards and learn all about the program. And if you're already there, you can check your balance and find out more about all the great deals that come with being a rewards member. And if you're getting ready for spring fishing, Fleet Farm is here to help you get all the gear you need. Shop their huge selection of rods and reels, plus check exclusive lures you won't find anywhere else. Find it all under one roof at Fleet Farm, your fishing headquarters. More from Buck and Honey's. It's Wilde and Tausch.
This is Wilde and Tausch on 94.5 ESPN, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin and sponsored by American Family Insurance. Even when you think you know what's going on, you can never be too sure.
I'm in the business of having a happy,
well,
a happy
life. We know who wears the pants in Josh's household.
Packers, nonsense, chaos.
Wait a minute. Who wears the pants in your household?
Not me.
Yeah. That felt a little glass houses there, bud.
Jen, Gabe, and Chewy. Morning 7 to 9 on 94.5 ESPN and available wherever you get your podcasts with Wisconsin On Demand.
Sleep apnea is a serious condition. And the worst part about it is, because it affects you while you're sleeping, you don't know what this condition is doing to you.
And it was scary because I found out that I was waking up 145 times an hour. 145 times. I was scared. I wasn't getting the sleep I needed.
And that's the thing. Someone like John wakes up after thinking he's slept all night, and he's been feeling run down for years, and finally finds out something really is wrong. This is why, for us, solving sleep apnea problems is so gratifying, because we really are changing lives.
I've had more energy. I'm getting better sleep. I've been told from my wife I don't snore, but honestly, it changed my life.
This is Dr. Madan Kandula. Solving your breathing triangle problems means a better quality of life, and you deserve that.
Go to AdventKnows.com to schedule your appointment, because Advent knows when you breathe well, you live better. Results may vary.
Beautify your entertainment space with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Hi, this is Gina Della from Pella. Turn your ordinary space into something extraordinary with brand new Pella Windows. Plus, getting the perfect windows and doors for your home has never been easier. Right now, get 0% interest for up to 36 months, or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th. Take ownership of your living space and make it a place worth living with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
Woo! Hey, this is Ben Brust from Kyle Brust and Ortman on ESPN Wisconsin. People can't stop screaming about the Screamin' Sicilian Frozen Pizza, and no wonder, there's plenty to scream about, like the buttery stone-fired crust, secret recipe tomato sauce, mounds of whole milk mozzarella, and tons of premium toppings. Find Screamin' Sicilian in your local grocer's freezer and find out for yourself why Sport called Screamin' Sicilian's Holy Pepperoni Frozen Pizza the best of the best. Screamin' Sicilian, taste what all the screaming is about.
Panic strikes as you realize on Wednesday that Thursday is your anniversary. The reservations? Being secured.
We'll see you at 8.
The gift? Being purchased. Yeah, you've got this. Just like Associated Bank's got you with early pay up to 2 days early on direct deposits. So even though they call you last minute Lisa, we'll make your last minute scrambling a bit easier. You've got this with early pay from Associated Bank. See associatedbank.com/checking or ask a banker for details. Member FDIC.
At some used car retailers like CarMax and Carvana, price is a bad word. You could pay thousands more for the same used car the Ewald Automotive Group sells. Shop over 600 live market priced used vehicles without worrying if you pay too much. Plus, we'll keep you on the road satisfaction guaranteed like we have for over 60 years. We make it easy because we service everything we sell.
Go to EwaldAuto.com.
ESPN Wisconsin's Mark Tauscher here, and there is one thing I think everyone can agree on. Potholes stink. And this year's weather will make it one of the worst years yet. Well, Johnson & Sons Paving is ready to take on the challenge with a team that has over two decades of experience. When the potholes pop up in your asphalt, Johnson & Sons Paving can patch or replace the whole area. Book an appointment now at johnsonandsonspaving.com. Get that appointment booked before May 31st, and you might even see Old T on the job site for a visit. Find full contest details at ESPN Wisconsin. WisconsinContest.com.
You're listening to Wildy and Tausch on 94.5 ESPN, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Call Gina Della from Pella at 855-PELLA-WI or visit online at PellaWI.com/radio.
Thanks again to Rasheed Walker for joining us from the Packers tailgate tour bus. Boy, it really is all about seniority, and young guys really do get all the assignments that other people don't want, like talking to us, don't they?
Yeah, that's how the world works, especially in professional sports.
That's what I was just going
to
say.
I feel like it works that way in most businesses, too, probably to a much lesser degree. But sports, there's a hierarchy.
Mm-hmm.
And you grow into hopefully getting to a spot, and it's not like it used to be. I'm not talking about hazing and all the other stuff.
Right.
I'm talking about you earn veteran status. There's some perks that come with being a vet.
So, Jesse, do you have veteran status at ESPN Madison?
I mean,
like, are you like telling Riley Yauch to do like the
let's ask it this way. Does Jesse handpick where and when he does play-by-play? I think the answer is yes.
Yes, I do. Yeah.
So actually, he does have status. Well. Yes.
He does like to go on, be the remote producer on site a lot when it comes with food and
restaurants and sliding down Bernie's slide. I know we're still working on trying to get this year. Yeah, if there's something in it for me, I tend to put myself in the situation to succeed. And yeah, so I would say yes. That's probably where we're at, I guess.
So. I think it was important that you're at Buck and Honey's. I'm not complaining. I'm thankful that you're there. Mm-hmm. When did you let Riley know that he would be coming out of the bullpen and producing from the Everlight Solar ESPN Madison studios?
He's had a week's notice. I was looking forward to the three of us all being here together and hanging out.
Sorry to disappoint
you. Getting lunch after the show.
Oh, great.
Having some hangout time that we don't usually have together.
You know what we have to start doing? We have to get Jason's haircut schedule and then plan our remotes around his haircuts.
Yeah.
That's what we need to do.
Or I need one for a while.
If we came to Green Bay, would he come out with us or would he stay in his basement?
Definitely, if you're going to get married, he's not going to come out. You know that.
I believe when we do the show from the Tundra Trio that we are together, and it is always a fun time, and I look forward to the next time that you guys are in town. I know you won't be here for the draft. I will be. The draft is less than 3 weeks away now. We're getting close.
Less than two weeks away,
yeah. I guess it was yesterday. Tausch, I one last thing on the offensive line before we move forward. If there is one position you are worried about on this team, what is it? Because I'm not, even with new starters or less than ideal experienced starters, I'm really not worried about the offensive line. I guess I could be worried about the depth of it. But if their starting five in Brazil is the starting five that it would be if they started the season today, I think I'm pretty much okay with that group. Even Josh Myers, who came on last season and played a lot better than he did early in the year at center.
Yeah, it's just that can you keep everybody healthy for that entire time? And if you can, great. If you can't, that's when you start worrying because you lost a lot of your depth throughout with Runyon, you know, Yosh being gone. So that would be the question that I would have. So you can never have enough good offensive linemen. I think we all know that. And then it just comes down to do you feel good about the people starting? Sure. You feel good about it, but you can never have enough guys at that position, and that's why I think every year you need to make sure you keep replenishing what you're doing.
Is there anything on the roster other than special teams, which we talked a little bit about yesterday, that you would say legitimately concerns you?
Yeah, I mean, I think you have to wonder about the inside linebackers. Do you have enough depth or who's there? And I know, I think Quay is the only guy under contract after next year, so that's a position especially – as you move forward with this new defense, how are you going to? You're going to have enough impact guys. That's a position I would think that they're going to look pretty heavy at early in this draft process.
Well, I know they like Isaiah McDuffie, who is going into the final year of his contract, but I don't feel like that's a position. If Quay Walker is who they think he will be in their new system, I don't think that that's a position they're worried about either. They certainly need to add depth there as well, but they brought back Eric Wilson. They brought back Christian Welch, and I think they feel okay about their depth there. But you're right. They will certainly have opportunities to add in the draft in the coming days. Jesse, you found something interesting, and I did too after you sent it along. The Packers are in such an interesting place right now financially. There's this piece at ESPN.com about the highest paid players at all the different positions. And there was a period where Jair was the highest paid corner. Elton Jenkins was the highest paid guard briefly. David Bakhtiari was the highest paid left tackle. And now, basically all we're waiting for is for Jordan Love to be the highest paid quarterback potentially and set the market, because everyone else, so many young guys, they don't have a lot of expensive players anymore. I just thought this story was a really interesting glimpse into where they're at salary-wise. And, again, I just don't – it's interesting to me that there's so few Packers on the list. I think – is Jair the only one?
So when I was reading through it, unless I miss somebody, Jair Alexander is the only Packers player on the entire list, and it goes like three or four deep at every position around the NFL. So all 32 teams – every position giving you the three or four highest paid players, and it even divides it by category with guaranteed money versus next 3 years. Jair Alexander is the highest paid corner, and there's no other Packers player on the list at all.
Yeah, that is surprising. But you start looking at it, you had Bakhtiari, you had Rodgers, you had Devontae, and you completely flipped the entire roster. So Jair's high paid. You know, Kenny Clark, depending on what you end up doing with him, with his contract the way it is, you have to pick and choose when you can't pay every position. And you found out quickly when Green Bay did do that, you start losing some things and you have an injury or two, you can really get set back. But that day is going to be coming. And you don't want to be in a position where you're not paying guys, because that doesn't mean you have that type of players. Now, McKinney is probably going to be one of the highest paid safeties, correct?
He's not in the top three either in total per year or total guaranteed money. So they paid him a huge contract, but Derwin James, Minkah Fitzpatrick, Jesse Bates are all ahead of him. He does have an annual average of $16.7 million. That puts him third in terms of average per year.
Well, you know what? That's the plus of having first and second year players play as well as you did. Then it's, are you going to take advantage of it? You went and picked up Jacobs. You went and picked up McKinney. You still have more to play with. I wouldn't be shocked if, you know, the draft doesn't fall right. Maybe there's a veteran that's not one of those high-priced guys. You go out, snap up for a year to kind of let that roll.
We'll get to some of your texts from the Talk of Text line, 844-770-3776, coming up next. Tausch and Jesse are live from Buck and Honey's in Sun Prairie as the Packers tailgate tour rolls on. Want to remind you, the official bank of the Packers is, of course, Associated Bank. And if you're looking to make the switch, there's no better time to do it than right now. Not only do you get the best customer service in the industry, but you also can sign up for Packers checking, associatedbank.com/Packers, to find out more. You get 10% off the Packers Pro Shop in-store and online. You get a nifty Packers debit MasterCard, and I think we've got some events that might be right around the corner, so keep an eye out for that as well. associatedbank.com/Packers to find out more. More Wildy and Tausch live from Buck and Honey's in Sun Prairie. Stick around.
This is Wildy and Tausch. Wildy and Tausch continues next on 94.5 ESPN, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin and sponsored by American Family Insurance.
They say seeing is believing, and when you see what's inside at American Place Casino, you better believe you're gonna love it. Because when it comes to amazing gaming, we're a real game changer. With the most exciting of table games like blackjack, craps, and roulette, the newest slots, a sportsbook, restaurants, bars, and more. So if you're ready for excitement, we'll see you soon. American Place Casino, change the game.
Must be 21 years of age or older. If you or someone you know has a gambling problem, crisis counseling and referral services can be accessed by calling 1-800-GAMBLER, 1-800-426-2537.
It's our lowest prices of the season at Blaine's Farm and Fleet. Right now, shop unbeatable deals on the things you need for spring. Like Scott's Turf Builder Lawn Food, $49.99 after sale and $10 mail-in rebate. Save $5 on Scott's Turf Builder Triple Action with Weed Killer, Crabgrass Preventer, and Lawn Food, $74.99 after sale and rebate. And Scott's Grub X Season Long Grub Killer, just $22.99 after mail-in rebate. Don't miss our lowest prices of the season in-store or online at farmandfleet.com.
The only thing that tops our selection is your savings discount liquor.
Take me out to the ball game, roll out the barrel, and get up, get out of here, gone. There's nothing like Milwaukee baseball. The Brew Crew is back, and we're here to help you turn your tailgate or game viewing experience into a grand slam. Hi, this is Marie from Discount Liquor, where since 1960, we have provided the best selection and the lowest prices. We stock literally thousands of varieties of beer, liquor, wine, and mixers, over 15,000 actually. But who's counting? The point is, you want it, odds are we have it. Combine our incredible selection and everyday low prices with our two convenient locations, and you've got your one-stop shop for game day. Discount Liquor in Milwaukee on 51st and Oklahoma, only 10 minutes from AmFam Field, and in downtown Waukesha on Barstow and Main. Discount Liquor.
ESPN Wisconsin's Mark Tauscher here for my friends at Kohler Services. If you need a bath or shower remodel, turn to Kohler Services. Family owned for 150 years, Kohler is your Wisconsin manufacturer providing care for life. And this month only, pay zero interest for 12 months and get a free shower door with your Lugstone shower remodel. Visit KohlerServicesWI.com to request your free quote with fast, professional installation always included. That's KohlerServicesWI.com.
Life's better with American Family Insurance because our home policies help protect your dreams and come with peace of mind. Save up to 25% by bundling home, auto, and life. American Family Insurance. Get a quote, find an agent at amfam.com.
Products not available in every state. Discounts may not apply to all coverages on an auto or home policy. Discounts do not apply to life insurance policies. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating companies, American Family Life Insurance Company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
The biggest names in the basketball world.
Dame Dollar Lillard.
Having fun and honest conversations.
He puts it in the shoe, right? And sets the tone for brothers and sisters and family.
Every week, Thanasis Adetokounmpo sits down with special guests on the Analysis Show, presented by Potawatomi Casino Hotel and Curbless Ready to Drink Cocktails. Fantastic. Find the Analysis Show on Spotify, Apple, or wherever you get your podcasts, and on YouTube by searching the Analysis Show.
Is your business looking for localized banking solutions and a strategic partner? Fifth Third Bank has been looking forward to the future and helping businesses shape what's next for 165 years and for the last 15 here in Milwaukee. They offer industry-specific expertise, local decision-making capabilities, and extensive experience to help navigate the complexities of a constantly changing business market environment. With your business in mind, commercial banking value only Fifth Third can deliver. Fifth Third Bank, National Association, custom solutions built around your goals. Member FDIC.
You're listening to Wildy and Tausch on 94.5 ESPN. Missed any of the show? Find us on Wisconsin On Demand wherever you get your podcasts. It's free, it's everywhere, and it's for you.
Continuing live, well, me from my basement, but Jesse and Tausch live from Buck and Honey's. Did I hear a rumor that Tommy is there and he's going to join us coming up later in the show?
I can confirm that rumor better than I can confirm what was going to happen from the tailgate tour bus. I can confirm that Tommy Anderson's going to hop on with us in a few minutes, yeah.
Jesse, you had some texts that you wanted to get to before Tommy joins us and fills that empty seat. What's gotten your attention on the text line?
So since we're talking so much offensive line, Ian in East Troy has sent in a text. And there's always a Badgers player that I think we as Packers fans kind of fall in love with as we get closer to draft time. So Ian in East Troy asks, would you reach for Tanner Bordellini and draft him in, like, the fourth round because of his versatility on the interior, whether it's guard or center?
Anytime you have to ask a question, would you reach? The answer should be no. Not when you're in this position. If you're, you know, sitting there and you don't have anyone and it's a spot that you're desperate for, you're in a bad spot. But I think Tanner Bordellini, when he joined us, we saw what he did at the combine. He put on good tape. I don't think he's going to be around late fourth, and I don't think you're going to reach. You're going to get a really good football player if
right.
Tanner Bordellini becomes the guy that you're thinking about. So, no, you should never be thinking that way. And especially, I think Green Bay is in such a good position that even if it is safety or one of these spots that we really feel like they need to add another piece, I think Goody is disciplined enough to just say, listen, man, this is the way our board looks. This is a really good football player. We're taking this player at this spot at this time.
But if you're it's not prize picks necessarily, but if you're predicting, you think it's more likely they make a trade and target someone and move up and give up some draft picks than stay put and pick every round, right? Aren't you?
I'm looking more at that, you know, third, fourth round where you can sit and keep accumulating and you want to bring talent in. But that's the case where, oh, that center dropped. Oh, that, or this safety that we kind of had valued a little bit higher than maybe other people did, they've fallen. They're not going to get to us at 70 or whatever pick that's going to be. Let's move up. We'll give up a fourth to move up to 15 spots. And then this is that's more along the lines. I'm actually going to be interested if Green Bay, with all of the quarterbacks that are going to go, is there going to be somebody that really values and maybe Green Bay trades out of 25? The thing with Goody is we've seen him be very aggressive as far as taking picks with Jair. Right? He traded out of, I think it was the 16th spot, right, and moved back up after I think New Orleans gave him that first-round pick for the next year. Then they moved back up because, all right, well, we have this extra capital. We got the first round for next year, and we really like Jair Alexander, so we're going to trade with Seattle and move back into the early 20s to get a player we really like. So the thing with the draft, it's so unknown. You don't have a clue until you start seeing how the board goes. But from a Packer fan standpoint, you want to see a ton of quarterbacks go before that 25th pick because that means there's a lot of really good position players that are falling further than they should.
Jesse, what else has gotten your attention on the text line?
Don in Mayville asks a question that, Jason, I think you have a chance here to match Domovsky's heat, the fire that he was bringing when he joined us.
So someone in the building told me.
This is your chance. Don in Mayville, are there any Packer trade rumors?
Someone in the building told me that there's been conversations about that 16th pick with the Seattle Seahawks, which we've all talked about ad nauseum. So, no, nothing.
Call Schneider and ask him.
I usually text with him more than call him.
Just text him right now and just say, hey, we're on the show. Any truth to the rumor that you're thinking about dumping 16 to the Packers?
So if you're John Schneider, because the point that you just made is an excellent one. If those quarterbacks are all coming off the board, even ones that truly don't deserve to go in the top 10, but because of the position they play will do so, and you push down further good players that play positions other than quarterback, that 16th pick gets increasingly more valuable, right? Especially if there are GMs that believe that there's a drop-off somewhere around 20 to, there's a lot of guys that are about the same between 20 and 55 or whatever it might be. If you're John Schneider, I don't care if you're buddies with Goody or not. First of all, you're in the same conference, so you're competing in the same NFC. But aren't you auctioning off that pick to the highest bidder? Packers aren't necessarily going to get it. And aren't you waiting until draft day to make that type of a trade because you want to extract the best deal you can from whomever is willing to pay it?
Are tomorrow's prices the same as today's?
No.
It could go the other way, too. It's just like buying stocks, buying Bitcoin. Yeah, it's great. Everybody now can sit and say, man, I should have bought 7,000 Bitcoin when it was at $17,000. Well, yeah, no blank. But you don't know these quarterbacks.
Is that a good price?
There's a lot of, you know, it's at 70-something now, so you can do the math on that. You can look at this and say, well, everybody's telling me J.J. McCarthy's going to be here and the Vikings are going to do this. Yeah, that's what everybody says, but that doesn't mean that's what's going to happen. So while you could sit there and say, well, yeah, I'm going to hold off and wait. Yeah, maybe that'll work. Or maybe you're going to get your best value right now because there's the uncertainty. So it's easy to sit and speculate and to do all that. But at some point, and this is where I think Minnesota is going to be aggressive because they keep talking about it.
Mm-hmm.
They're going to go, I think they know they need to bring somebody in, and I think they like somebody. And I don't necessarily know it's J.J. McCarthy, because good organizations, and obviously Minnesota has been up and down with that, you don't let people actually know what you're doing.
Right.
So that's why I think there's so much smoke and so much. They need to move the draft up. I'm getting a little drafted out if I'm shooting straight with you. There's just too much. Well, it's like, let's go. What are we doing?
It's been the same for years.
No, it hasn't. They moved it back a couple years ago, and it's dumb. Like, it should be. It's always been this time of the year, right around the Masters is when it happens. And you're actually hurting the young players by not letting them get in earlier. What are we doing, dragging it all the way to the end of April, early May? Move it back. But I understand you want to own calendars and you want to do it. But I would say the draft needs to move up at least one more week, and preferably two, because the draft industrial complex has plenty of time to get its stuff done. And I think you're actually not helping the young players, because you're not letting these guys find out where they're at until May. Season starts in September. Give them another month. Like, what are we doing?
I think you're right, though. You understand the fact that the NFL wants to own the calendar, and they want to do it this way. And
they're going
to
own the calendar.
But to Tausch's point, and this is why you just don't roll your eyes at old T. Do you know when Mark Tauscher was drafted in 2000, when the draft was that year? First of all, it was only 2 days. It was Saturday.
Saturday.
I don't have any problem at all with them going. If they want to go 4 days, they should go 4 days. Drag it out. Matter of fact, I thought the first round of the draft should be just the first, and you just do 10 picks each. Thursday 10, Friday 10, and then give it another week for the second round, and then just let it rip.
So you want to move it up.
Move it up and drag it out.
It when it's going on.
If you want to suck the calendar like they do, move it up. Have a Monday night draft. Start the draft week. Have it draft week. Start Monday, top 10 picks. Tuesday, next 10. Wednesday, and then go Thursday. We don't need to do 2 weeks. Thursdays, so round two, round three. And then Friday, boom, boom, you finish, it's over.
The 2000 NFL draft, to Tausch's point, was April 15th and 16th. So
and let me
it started 10 days
we
earlier
We all wanted
than
the
this
draft
year's.
To be the end of March.
But yeah. It's been over a decade since they've been doing this Thursday, Friday, Saturday, end of April.
It was like the 20th, 21st, 22nd the first few years, and then obviously now there have been years where it went the last day was like May 1st or May 2nd. And that is, Tausch is right, that goes too long. I'm not super excited about the fact that you're all drafted out and we still have 10
well,
days, 11
I'm not the only person
days.
That's drafted out. I mean, I think, listen, we'll continue to talk and we'll continue to evaluate, but this is the time of the year where it's all misinformation. It's misinformation most of the time. Now it's just who can spin the best story to try and get it. So, my point is, let's just get this thing rolling.
Yeah, I saw something earlier in the week where three different Giants beat writers had three different reports about three different quarterbacks that the Giants might be interested in, because clearly their GM is trying to get as much smoke out there as possible and try and drum up interest for their pick because of the quarterback question that some teams have, and they obviously have Daniel Jones. All right, well, there's no smoke when it comes to Coors Light. There are only Blue Mountains and Tausch's love for his favorite
brew. Coors Light brewed with a three-step cold process, cold lager, cold filtered, and it's cold packaged, so it's made to chill, born in the Rocky Mountains of Colorado in 1978. Coors Light's refreshing, it's crisp, only 102 calories. That's why it's Coors Light in my hand when I need a moment to chill. Sub responsibly, Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado.
Our friend Tommy Anderson from Buck and Honey's joins us live next. It's Wildy and Tausch.
We're on air, online, and on demand. Get all your favorite ESPN Wisconsin content anywhere you get your podcast for free. The new Wisconsin On Demand. It's free, it's everywhere, and it's for you. In season, off season, draft season. Whatever season it is, we are Milwaukee's place to talk green and gold. Listen, watch, or stream live whenever, wherever. 94.5 ESPN.
If only life had a remote control, you could pause or rewind. Well, life doesn't always give you time to change the outcome, but prediabetes does. Take the 1-minute risk test today at doihaveprediabetes.org. Brought to you by the Ad Council and its prediabetes awareness partners.
Thanks for calling Discover. This is Gabby.
Hey, Gabby. It's Jennifer Coolidge. Hi. I'm so glad I reached you at 2 a.m.
Oh, of course. Anyone with a Discover card can call and talk to a real person 24/7. Now, how can I help?
Yeah, I used my Discover card to buy these yellow pleather pajamas, and I'm just not sure I'm pulling them off.
24/7 U.S.-based customer service. It pays to Discover. Limitations apply. Learn more at discover.com/creditcard.
When Cynthia came to TurboTax, she just launched her new side gig, a true crime podcast.
I'm a first-rate detective with a golden voice.
As her TurboTax expert, I made her second income count by guaranteeing 100% accurate filing and her maximum refund.
What did she do with that refund? Find out next week.
Switch to Intuit TurboTax and make your moves count. See guarantee details at TurboTax.com/guarantees. Experts only available with TurboTax Live.
The IRS is the most powerful collection agency on earth. And if you owe back taxes, the news isn't good. The IRS is raising the interest rate it charges on unpaid taxes, and further rate hikes are expected. Most people don't know it, but the IRS adds interest charges on your tax debt daily. So if you owe the IRS today, you will owe even more tomorrow. And it doesn't stop until you get right with the IRS. The good news is, getting right can start with one phone call to Optima Tax Relief, America's number one tax relief firm. Optima's tax professionals specialize in the Fresh Start Initiative, a powerful IRS program that can save you thousands if you qualify. In fact, the experts at Optima Tax have resolved over $1 billion in tax debt for their clients. Call now for a free consultation.
Call 800-480-6932. That's 800-480-6932. 800-480-6932.
Optima Tax Relief.
Some restrictions apply. For complete details, please visit OptimaTaxRelief.com.
Hey, this is Brad Nortman here to tell you about my friends at Bank 5-9. Everywhere I go throughout the area, I see Bank 5-9, and it's no wonder why. Not only do they have 14 branch locations, but their employees spend nearly 9,000 hours each year volunteering in the communities that they serve. That's on top of the financial support that they provide to several hundred nonprofits right here in southeastern Wisconsin. If you're looking for a true local community bank, check them out today at bank59.com. Member FDIC.
Now's the time to make those big spring purchases at Fleet Farm. Husqvarna mowers, Minn Kota trollers, Goodyear tires. Fleet Rewards credit card members can enjoy special financing for 3 full years on qualifying purchases. So don't wait. There's never been a better time to get everything you need for everyday life at Fleet Farm. 36-month special financing available on in-store purchases of $1,499 or more after discounts made with your Fleet Rewards credit card. Now through May 1st, 2024. Subject to credit approval. Minimum monthly payments required. See customer service for details.
Wisconsin is still cattle country, and that's why Bunzl's chose to stay close to home to hand select the finest beef. Quality goes into everything they do, from Bunzl's expansive array of meats, homemade specialty sausages, and their award-winning beef jerky. It just isn't a proper holiday meal without Bunzl's top quality cuts on the dinner table. Tasting is believing. Bunzl's.com.
This is Wildy and Tausch on 94.5 ESPN. Sponsored by American Family Insurance. Insure carefully, dream fearlessly. Get a quote and find an agent at amfam.com.
Tausch and Jesse are live from Buck and Honey's. Not the Monona location. Not the Wanakee location. Not the Mount Horeb location. the Sun Prairie location. Tommy, you know you've been hearing the warden from the Shawshank Redemption film many times on this show. I tried to do my best imitation so everyone could hear your various locations. How are things with you, and how excited are you to have those two knuckleheads there and not me?
Well, good. I was really bummed out when I walked in and found out Wildy wasn't here.
Well, he didn't have a haircut.
He didn't have a haircut scheduled. You know, you can't get him out of the basement. It's tough.
Well, we miss you, Jason. Looking good, though. Thank you. Love the show. Listen to it every day. You guys are wonderful. And, yeah, you're doing some fun stuff. So we're really happy you guys are here. Thanks.
Tommy, you got any fun jokes? You always tell great stories when you come on. I don't know if I'm going to ask for any stories.
Put them on the spot.
You always got a couple of good jokes.
Right away with the good jokes. You know, there's a good restaurant joke, and we'll keep it clean, that I just heard that wasn't too bad. What did Sushi A, you like sushi, Tom.
Love sushi.
You do.
It's favorite food.
Yep. I know. What did Sushi A say to Sushi B?
I don't know.
What's up, B?
That did not disappoint.
Yeah, all right.
Pretty good.
You're welcome.
Tommy, what is your favorite food? So Jesse yesterday goes through this whole thing, and he's, I didn't know what your favorite food is. Like, who asks?
My wife, Becca, told me yesterday. She goes, what's Wildy and Tausch's favorite food? And I said, I've worked with them for 6 years. I don't know. I didn't know the answer. She's like, how do you not know? I know everybody's favorite food.
Do you know how many of your employees, that's their favorite food? Like, is that a question you ask people?
No, I don't know. It's a topic starter.
Sure.
I guess it's a conversation starter. But, no, if you talked about favorite food, if you asked my wife what her favorite restaurant is.
It's Buckin' Honey's.
No, she'd say our kitchen at home because she just likes to be home. You know that. So, but our
I respect that, by the way.
Yeah, yes. I married an introvert, so, you know, it was a very functioning introvert. But, the thin crust pizza here at Buck and Honey's is my dad's recipe. In 1977, he built Bomberino's in Lake Delton in the Dells. And I grew up making these pizzas. And then, our best sandwich, I think, is the TA's Hot Combi.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, with
good
the
stuff.
It's an Italian sandwich with creamy Italian, and it's delicious. So a lot of good options at Buck and Honey's. We make all of our own dressing, stock, soups, you name it. So you can't lose, man.
There's no doubt. Let's take Buck and Honey's out of the equation.
Yes.
Tommy Anderson just goes to get a meal. What are you getting?
No, I'm a sushi guy. I love
wasabi.
Wasabi. that's kind of like one of those, like, once a month you go out and get sushi.
Yeah.
You can't eat it all the time.
Okay.
But, yeah. Yeah, we've dined many good spots together.
Absolutely. Matter of fact, you were talking about Buck and Honey's pizza. Legit, I just said we were over in Italy for a nice stretch, and when we were there, Max and I both were like, we like Buck and Honey's pizza better than the pizza in Rome.
Yeah.
It's different there. It's simple, and I think it's just like an everyday food, whereas American pizza is better than Italian pizza.
Yeah, I've heard that before, and so thank you for saying that. Give Max a fist bump for me.
You got it.
Yeah.
All right, so Tommy, can you tell us a little bit about what your association is, with this whole event and what's going on?
Yeah, the Packer Tailgate Tour is really neat. We applied. I'm on the board with Sunshine Place to back up. So Sunshine Place is a one-stop shop for people in need in Sun Prairie. We built it about over 20 years now. But we house our Sun Prairie Emergency Food Pantry, a bunch of social services in there, and we're really doing a lot of good things for people in need in Sun Prairie. And it's really a neat concept because it's all under one roof for people to come see. And we've grown it substantially over the years. But we always need funding to keep this going. The need for food security and just all the social services that we offer, it never ends. And the population growth is pretty strong here in Sun Prairie, as you know. So we're really proud of being able to help those people. But our executive director, Ann Maastricht, she applied for this, just seeing if we can get lucky and get these funds from the Packers. And also it brings a really neat vibe to the community. Mm-hmm. So we're going to host a VIP party here from like 4:30 to 5:30 this afternoon. And then there's a large, I think, ticketed event that I'm pretty sure sold out mm-hmm. at Angel Park. And there's going to be a live auction where we help raise a bunch of money. But Mark Murphy's going to be here. I think he's bringing like two or three current Packers and mm-hmm. some veterans. I know Mark will be there, which will be great. And a bunch of ESPN contingencies. I think Jim Rutledge is even maybe doing a show from there tonight.
Yeah.
So we really appreciate the support from ESPN with this whole Packer tailgate tour. It should be a lot of fun. And we love having the Packers here. And just coming to Sun Prairie is a pretty cool thing for us.
Mm-hmm.
for the community.
Tommy, how, I've told you this before, but I love the story behind Buck and Honey's and who they were and all those aspects to your business side. But how did you get involved with Sunshine Place? Because when Jesse was talking about it earlier, like, it basically covers all the bases of the challenges that disadvantaged folks face, and whether it's food insecurity or housing or whatever it is, you guys are on top of all those things.
Yeah, I think that's a good question how it started. I was in a, it's called Sun Prairie Leadership back in, like, again, 20 years ago, with a group of people, and we toured the emergency food pantry that was downtown Sun Prairie. And this thing had, like, holes in the ceiling, I mean, refrigeration that was broken down, and it was just, I mean, it was not even a safe place to be, much less functional for long term. So we did a big raise. There's a couple families in town that did large capital contributions that are very generous to help kick this off. And we raised about $1 million back then, which was a ton of money, to build Sunshine Place. All privately done. We didn't go to the city, the government. We really wanted to be, bipartisan. It was really contributions from the community to build it. And what that really did was just come together and allow other organizations to go under one roof, Jason, so that it's been really neat to be a part of it and see it grow with a lot of people. We've got a really strong board of over 15 people on the board and stuff. So yeah, it's a neat story. And Buck and Honey Birkebein, they once farmed and owned all the land in our original location here in Sun Prairie. They were big stewards of the community too, so we kind of like to follow that spirit with this too. So definitely.
All right, I have two questions about the VIP event that I'm not attending.
I got an extra ticket, Jason. You know, move your haircut or take the girls to gymnastics tomorrow. I don't know.
My first question is, because obviously Tausch and I and Jesse, because of what we do, we talk to Brian Bulaga every week, or Mike Daniels is on the show. You're a Packers fan. I've seen you up at our pregame shows at the Tundra Trio before. If you have an opportunity during your VIP session, is there someone you want to talk to from the contingent that's there? Like, Mike Daniels, I think, is going to trump the wasabi joke with his entertainment level. Is he your first-round pick?
No, Mark Murphy is by far. That'll be fun. I'll ask him that question for the 16th seed if that rumor is true.
He might share.
He might, actually.
I'll just give him a couple martinis and maybe that'll work.
And then the only other thing I'm wondering as a Buck and Honey's fan is, this is a chance to make me feel even worse about not coming down. Will the firecracker shrimp be on the menu tonight? The bacon wrapped dates, which I've had. I love the salmon there and the scallops. What are people going to be eating at the VIP event that I'm missing out on?
You're making me hungry talking about it. Yeah, we've got a great spread of all those things you just mentioned and a few other surprises that our chefs are working on. You know, I just met with our chefs yesterday. We have our new menu rolling out in the first week of May for the summer. We rotate our menus regularly, and the patios are rocking. We've got them pressure washed all week. And
going to be open this week.
Patio season. Ring the bell. That means patio season starting. And so we're excited for that, and a lot of fun things happening at Buck and Honey's with live music and great food and just a good vibe and experience for our guests to come out and see us. So thank you.
And I can get filet for lunch, which is what I try to do whenever I'm on Tausch's dime.
Yeah. Well, we wish you were here, Jason, and we're sending all the best. And I'm excited for the Masters this weekend too. You guys have
Let's
a lot of talk.
Let's get that on. Yeah. Flip that up.
Yeah, we got it right here.
It's right in front of you on every TV.
But we'll get it over here for you.
Okay, Josh. Thanks, buddy. Yeah. It's nice that somebody's here looking out for me. Yeah.
You found the one TV it's not on. It's on like five other ones.
Yeah, it's
fair enough.
It's a good. It's going to be a good.
That's
weekend.
The best. Is that not the best viewing? Like, if you're just going to watch on TV, sit back. Isn't it the best?
Yeah. I planned something many years ago for this weekend.
I do remember that.
Yeah. Well, hey, you guys have a great weekend, and thanks again to ESPN. You guys are such great partners to Buck and Honey's and Sunshine Place and just all you guys do. We appreciate you coming out and spending some time with us. It's awesome.
Tommy, we appreciate you, man. Thanks.
All right. Thanks, Jason.
Thank you.
Take care.
Tausch, you mentioned the Masters. Can you do Prize Picks with the Masters?
Yeah, Prize Picks has it all. It's the number one fantasy sports app. 3 million active members. All you do is pick more or less on 2 to 6 player stat projections, and you can watch the winnings roll in. And this weekend you have some combat fighting. You got some golf. You got basketball. You got baseball. And my guy.
Your guy. Legend.
Justin Gaethje.
Nope.
Gaethje.
Nope.
Gaethje.
Nope.
Gaethje.
Nope.
How do you say it?
Gaethje.
God, how do I get it wrong?
Gaethje.
Justin Gaethje. 0.5 strikes. Not a free square, but, man, that is a good one to jump on. You got that. Prize Picks has it all. Download the app. Use the code WI for a first deposit match up to $100. That's code WI on Prize Picks for a first deposit match of up to $100. Pick right. more, pick less. It's that easy.
Riley's producing. He's like Mr. UFC. Do you need his insight on this at all?
Oh, somebody could good have jumped idea.
In yeah, somebody could have jumped in and helped. But
I was
right
trying to. I tried to say it's Justin Gaethje.
Gaethje.
Yep.
Gaethje.
Yep.
Gaethje.
You got it.
You listen. We've been telling him all week. Now you're going to listen to him the last time you're saying it?
Good news is the fight's Saturday, so that'll be the last time you hear it from him.
Tausch and Jesse and anyone else who randomly walks by the camera live from Buck and Honey's. The 11 o'clock hour kicks off in 2 minutes, so stick around.
Don't go anywhere. Another hour of Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin, is coming up next on ESPN Wisconsin, the ESPN app, and Wisconsin On Demand.
Mark Tauscher here, and these days I am sleeping better than ever. I am so thankful I met with the great team at Advent to help solve my sleeping problems. The Advent team is so great to work with, and their consultations are very informative. The Advent team listened to my struggles, and rather than forcing a surgery, they helped me find the best solution for a better night's sleep. My family and I are so thankful the solutions from Advent worked. To see how they can help you with snoring, sleep apnea, and nasal breathing problems, go to AdventKnows.com, because Advent knows when you breathe well, you live better.
Right now, the prices of diamonds are probably the lowest we'll see in our lifetime.
Diamond prices are low, low, low. Here's why.
It was hard to meet new people during COVID.
When a person meets their soulmate, they usually get engaged about 39 months later.
People started dating again only about 36 months ago.
Most of the people who got engaged during COVID
or immediately after COVID
were already in a relationship before the COVID lockdown began.
The Wall Street Journal even published a story about all of this.
Low sales of engagement rings created a worldwide oversupply of diamonds.
But now, engagement ring sales are beginning to pick up again.
By the end of next spring, this temporary oversupply will be gone.
And diamond prices will start climbing like crazy.
If you ever want to own a big diamond, this is the year to do it.
Find the Kesslers nearest you at KesslersDiamonds.com.
If you want to own a big diamond, the time is now.
Multiple sclerosis is an unpredictable, often disabling disease of the central nervous system. We need to show support to people with MS, and one way is through Walk MS, which is brand new in 2024. We embrace and are committed to bringing our entire MS community together, representative of all the various dimensions of our community, so that everyone feels at home and supported by the National MS Society. The excitement is building for the new Walk MS. Come see the community come together like never before. Visit walkms.org today and plan to join us around Wisconsin.
Hey, this is Gabe Neitzel. You're listening to 94.5 ESPN, WKTI and WKTI HD, Milwaukee.
A locally owned Good Karma brand station. I'm not giving up, giving up, no, not yet. Even when I'm down on my last breath. Even when they say there's nothing left. So don't give up on. I'm not giving up. I'm not giving up, giving up, no, not me.
Thanks to Tommy Anderson and the crew at Buck and Honey's. Not Monona, not Mount Horeb. Not Wanakee, Sun Prairie, where Jesse and Tausch are doing the show live with the Packers tailgate tour making its way to Sun Prairie and its charitable event for Sunshine Place later in the day. Tausch, I know you get you entertain yourself with your Domofsky's your favorite beat writer, Silverstein.
Yeah, both really good. A lot of scoopage.
But one of the things that I don't think you would push back on, or maybe you would, is that when it comes to telling the stories of not just you, but every Packer I've covered, I am inclined toward the positive. You'd say that's fair, don't you?
Yeah, I think that's a fair assessment.
Mm-hmm. So I thought it was, and look, that doesn't mean that there aren't times where you have to write something that is not positive, as Mike McCarthy might say. But Riley's got this audio. I want to play it here. Jared Goff, who played in L.A., went to a Super Bowl with the Rams, was traded to Detroit. Matthew Stafford goes to L.A. and wins a Super Bowl in his place. But Jared Goff, whatever you think of him as a player, has played well for them, and they have had success.
Yep.
Especially for a franchise that has not had a whole hell of a lot of success over the last, I don't know, 5-6 decades. And so he was doing a podcast, the Trading Cards Podcast. I don't know if he was talking about his, you know, his favorite Topps 1993 cards or what he was discussing, but he was also discussing the negativity of the media covering the Lions. Here is Jared Goff talking about that on the Trading Cards Podcast.
So unfortunately, Twitter is not working right now. I'm getting a media could not be played on both computers we have here. I don't know what that issue is, but I guess I could play it off my phone and put it up to the mic.
Is it weird? I thought Riley Yauch was Goff. I'm like, what the hell are you guys doing? It sounds like Goff.
They have the same voice.
All right, let's just do it this way. Okay, so
I can read what he said. It's in an article. I could read
it. There is some, you know, some technical glitches,
it's
which happens
right here.
Riley,
I'm watching.
Read what Goff and do it in Goff's voice, and just say what he said.
Where is this article?
Oh,
where
God. It says,
I just have the video.
This is like the time that Riley gets the opportunity on the show and then oversleeps and almost misses.
Riley, let's talk about you.
It's not his fault. Right, Twitter's
Riley,
down.
Let's talk about you.
I can send you a picture of what Twitter is showing me right now.
Let's
this
talk about
Youngster's
girlfriend. Riley, tell me more. How did it go when you went and met your girlfriend's parents?
It went really well. She has a great family.
All right, so what? Give us a little play-by-play. So you just started dating and you went up to... Give us the scoop. I think I missed the day you subbed. Let me hear the scoopage on that.
Yeah, okay. So I'll run it back for you. I think Jason's already heard this. I think it was...
not everybody listens every day.
Yeah,
so
yeah,
true.
Yeah, but I do. Can I leave?
Yeah, go ahead.
Take a break.
I'm reading Jared Goff's article right now.
Yeah, okay. I'll just keep going then.
Do you want him to tell the story? Do you want the Goff stuff?
What I don't
do you
know
wanna, what do you want to do right now?
I don't
now?
Know what I want. Read the Goff stuff. Let's go.
Okay, thank goodness.
I have this, like, I probably need to drop it pretty soon here because I'm hopefully going to be in Detroit for a long time. But I have this thing with our local media where, like, they almost, like, relish in negativity at times.
I don't think you need to read all the likes.
Well, it's quoted in the story, so I feel like, and maybe that's what gets clicks and that's what sells, but it's no longer what they need to live in. Like, hey guys, we have a good team. We've had success.
Like,
we can I'm just trying to get us through it, Jason. We can be happy about that. We can celebrate that and not have to write about how we're constantly the underdog. No, teams are going to be gunning for us now. We won the division and all that. I'm probably overthinking it in my head, and it's the chip on my shoulder and the competitor in me.
Mm.
Jared Goff said on the podcast, what was it called?
Yeah,
Trading Cards.
What I thought, why I thought this was interesting when I sent it over is because, you know, when you look at how the Packers are covered, do you think they're covered in a negative way, Jason?
When things go bad, yes, but not as like the predisposition of the media, but this is kind of like the argument that I would get about I wasn't critical enough of Aaron Rodgers during his time playing. Aaron Rodgers won 4 MVPs.
Yeah, but he fell short in the playoffs every year.
Right. And when he didn't play well in the playoffs, we talked about it. But it's when you're the Lions and you have this culture of losing, there's a lot of negativity to go around because there's a lot to be negative about.
Yeah, but what I found interesting is there have not been a lot of negativity for 18 months.
Right.
Middle half of 2 years ago. And the fact that Goff goes on a podcast and to say it, I think there's some self-loathing up there. And I think there's also the fallback. So I think Goff is looking at it and saying, what the heck is going on with this press? With this, you know, the beat that covers us. We have stunk forever. Now we're finally good, and you're still going to be this negative. And I believe he feels like it's because that's the business model y'all are in.
Yeah,
and I thought it was really interesting because New York, Philly, they have so much media. You're going to get a ton of negative. You're going to get Green Bay, I would say, is mostly positive. If you're not a defensive coordinator, I think it's mostly positive. If you look at Detroit, you have a season like they had where they just fell short.
Yeah, they made the NFC title game.
It should have been rose petals and flowers everywhere. And when it's not, I think the players can look at it and say, what the hell are you guys even doing?
So, but let me ask you this from our perspective on this show, because when we talk about the Packers here as compared to the Lions, I don't know about you, but they went to the NFC Championship game, and yet I think we both believe that if you had to pick who's going to win the NFC North this year, we'd pick the Packers. And not because we're homers, because we think they're the ones that are trending in a more positive direction. Not that the Lions are suddenly now going to bottom out after one NFC Championship game appearance, but I like the way the Packers are trending. I think the Lions are going to have some challenges. They're playing a first-place schedule, for example. Like, I don't know about you, but I don't think that that's being negative toward the Lions. I think that's just saying, look, it's hard to lord over a division the way the Packers did for long stretches in the NFC North. And the Packers, with their quarterback, seem like a team that could very well win the division instead of you. Wouldn't you agree?
What does Las Vegas say?
I can get that for you right after.
I don't believe that most people think that the Green Bay Packers should be favored over Detroit. I don't. Now, does that mean I don't think our fans and the people listening to this show or people that live in Wisconsin or people that are Packer fans? I totally understand why you'd say what you just said. But Detroit has earned the right to have that. And they're not, it's not like they've regressed a bunch. Their O-line's still going to be really good. Their backs and, you know, their wideouts have gotten a year older, too. Their quarterback is more seasoned than Jared Love. Jordan Love, Jared Goff. Hmm. That's the part that I think is going to be. Now, defensively, who would you rather have? The fact that their offensive coordinator stayed. I think the Packers should openly embrace. I don't think they're going to get it. But I think you should embrace it. Well, Detroit's the king of the North, man. So we got to take it from him.
You have it, Jason?
Yeah, so help me understand this, because you guys are better at this than me. The Vikings are the longest shots in the NFC North, according to four different sports books. I've got one that's got a composite of all of them.
ESPN Bet is our personal favorite in these parts, Jason.
I understand. But the bottom line is the Lions are plus 150 to win the NFC North. The Packers are plus 225. The Bears are plus 350.
Well, that's not. I thought it'd be more.
Yeah. And the Vikings are plus 750.
Yeah.
So that means that if you wagered $100 on the Lions winning the division, you would win 150 if they did it?
That's correct. Yes.
And the Packers, you would win 225. So the Lions are favored across. And, Jesse, the reason I did this is because, you know, look, some places view different conferences or different divisions differently, but this is unanimous.
Mm-hmm.
All four of these sports books, including ESPN Bet, have the Lions as the favorite. So it's if they're being negative in Detroit, that would be surprising to me. If it's negative here on Wilde and Tausch about them compared to the Packers, that's probably not as surprising.
I'm also seeing the Lions plus 550 to win the NFC. Only the 49ers have better odds than that. The Packers are plus 1,000 to win the NFC, so nearly double the odds for the Packers to actually reach the Super Bowl.
Yeah, and I think for people that are going to bet, I like the odds with Green Bay a heck of a lot more than I like with Detroit.
Mm-hmm.
So are we overvaluing the team that we watch most closely? Because I would argue throughout the years of this show, we more often than not focused on the flaws and why they might not be a favorite or why they might not be able to get
it done. That's Jared Goff's point. You're proving his point is that there is, and I think his deal – Like, when you're the New England Patriots, that's how the world works. Like, it's championship or bust. The Green Bay Packers just had a unprecedented run of great regular season success, some playoff success, a couple of championships. But if you ask most Packer fans, they're disappointed you only got two.
Right.
And is that does that mean that Packer fans are negative? No. It means their expectations are higher. Detroit fans hadn't won a playoff game since JFK blown away. What else do I have to say?
Well, Aaron Rodgers said a lot about JFK apparently the other day.
Anyways, yeah. That when you start looking at it that way, I think Jared Goff's point is, why don't we love the fact that we're actually good? Instead of sitting here saying, well, the defensive backfield stinks, and the linebackers need to be faster, and all this other stuff. That's his point. And one thing you learn is you're never going to win going against the media. They always have the last say. So I don't know how that's going to be viewed by his folks or your colleagues in the media there, is that typically goes the other way when you fight fire. That's why everybody's so nice to you guys, is because they hope that brings positive coverage.
All right. Well, I didn't think that the coverage of the Lions, but I read a few of those guys on a fairly regular basis, so I'm a little surprised that Jared Goff.
But we can agree that Jared Goff would read and see more than what we would.
I don't know. Maybe he shouldn't be, right?
Was he implying that, like, writers nationally, locally, whomever, saying that they're the underdog is a bad thing? Like, don't players want that mentality most of the time?
I really think it was more they focused on the negatives rather than the fact that we won two playoff games for the first time in forever. And, you know, the realization.
Because they were up big in the NFC Championship.
The realization is
nothing lead.
Yeah. Nobody really cares, man. It's always about what you're going to do next. And that's something Detroit has never had to deal with. That's another thing, handling success. And Dan Campbell knows it. You know, I loved how honest he was talking about he doesn't know if they'll ever even get back to the point where they're at. And that's why these things hurt so much, is because I'm not going to go back because that analogy didn't get the love that I wanted last time. It's the Mount Everest deal. And I'm not going to go into the great detail.
Who are you, Jared Goff?
It's just
Goff?
The analogy.
Yeah. When it comes to analogies,
what else you got, Jared?
You only got the negativity.
That was great. We praised the Mount Everest analogy up and down, literally and figuratively.
Good one.
We also praise Quick Trip up and down. We always love our stops there when Sydney and Maddie and I stop there on our travels. So do Tausch and his family.
It's baseball season, so it's time for me and you to take a quick trip to the ballpark. For every $200 you spend at Quick Trip with Quick Rewards, you'll earn a free ticket to a Brewers game of your choice. That's right, big savings and free Brewers tickets. Visit the Quick Rewards app. Click on the Fan Zone button on the app. Home screen to opt in, and you can start redeeming your tickets. You can redeem up to 6 Brewers tickets at a time.
Wow.
And who doesn't want to go to a Brewers game for free?
I do.
Using your Quick Rewards, you can go get all those samples, stuff your face, and you can get those Brewers points from Quick Rewards in addition to Quick Rewards.
I don't think that was in there.
Double the points. Double the happiness. Blackout dates and upgrade fees may apply. See quicktrip.com/ballpark. To get it rolling.
Stuff your face with all the samples. Let's play some trivia.
One time.
Jesse, what do you got for today's category, and what caller would you like Riley to get?
In honor of the Green Bay Packers on the tailgate tour, what's the latest update from them, old T? Where are the Packers tailgate tour? Where are they right now?
How the hell do I know?
Because we...
What do you think? I have a tracker.
I think he was setting you up for they're roasting hot dogs in the
parking
lot.
They're outside. They got the fire and the hot dogs.
I kind of thought that bit got stale.
Murphy's telling stories. Never mind. Packers on the tailgate tour.
I didn't know where we were.
Is the category. Packers on the tailgate tour. Let's do caller 10 for Jordan Love.
Caller 10, 844-770-3776, 844-770-3776. Riley Yauch is standing by trying to get the audio of Jared Goff to play.
Give up.
like, call now so, like, Riley can, like, answer the phone and we can play trivia.
Like, why does Jared Goff say like that many times? He's a professional quarterback, done, in, like, a million interviews. It drives me nuts when my kids say like, because I want to get it out of their lingo.
Yeah.
Jesse's reading the transcript. He said like
why would they put that in the transcript? Just take that out of the transcript.
Like, totally. Like, that's a sweet thing that the Lions like. Like, what are, come on, Jared. You're the franchise quarterback, man. You've been around 10 years. Or I don't know how many years he's been, but it's been 8 or 9 years. Clean it up, brother.
You should, like, be better than that. Caller 10 right now, 844-770-3776. Trivia's next. It's Will Dean Tausch.
Will Dean and Tausch is presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Call Gina Della from Pella at 855-PELLA-WI or visit online at PellaWI.com/radio.
Hey, it's Ben Brust, and join me for a look back on one of the most memorable basketball seasons in Badger history. A banner year, the story of the 2014 Wisconsin Final Four team, featuring great conversations with Bo Ryan, Frank Kaminsky, Barstool Big Cat, Ian Eagle, and more.
Wisconsin is headed to the Final Four.
Find it on ESPN Milwaukee's YouTube, live on 94.5 ESPN, and wherever you get your podcast.
Beautify your entertainment space with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Hi, this is Gina Della from Pella. Turn your ordinary space into something extraordinary with brand new Pella windows. Plus, getting the perfect windows and doors for your home has never been easier. Right now, get 0% interest for up to 36 months, or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th. Take ownership of your living space and make it a place worth living with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
The Delafield Brewhouse, celebrating 25 years. This award-winning restaurant and brewery is on the corner of I-94 and Highway 83 in Delafield. Dine in or carry out in the heart of Lake Country. Drink ale, live lager. The Delafield Brewhouse.
The Bucks are back on broadcast TV. Tonight, watch the Milwaukee Bucks on WMLW VM. And you don't need a streaming service to see this matchup. Just tune in to WMLW VM starting at 6:30 on over-the-air channel 49. Also on Spectrum, DirecTV, Dish, and others. The Bucks back on broadcast TV. Tonight versus the Thunder on WMLW VM starting at 6:30. Visit WMLW.com for everything Bucks.
Thanks for calling Discover. This is Gabby.
Hey, Gabby. It's Jennifer Coolidge. Hi. I'm so glad I reached you at 2 a.m.
Oh, of course. Anyone with a Discover card can call and talk to a real person 24/7. Now, how can I help?
Yeah, I used my Discover card to buy these yellow pleather pajamas, and I'm just not sure I'm pulling them off.
24/7 U.S.-based customer service. It pays to Discover. Limitations apply. Learn more at discover.com/creditcard.
When Cynthia came to TurboTax, she just launched her new side gig, a true crime podcast.
I'm a first-rate detective with a golden voice.
As her TurboTax expert, I made her second income count by guaranteeing 100% accurate filing and her maximum refund.
What did she do with that refund? Find out next week.
Switch to Intuit TurboTax and make your moves count. See guarantee details at TurboTax.com/guarantees. Experts only available with TurboTax Live.
Sharon needed legal help. She needed Gruber Law Offices.
When I think about Gruber Law Office, I think about how they took care of me, how they make sure that you get what you're supposed to get. Gruber Law Office. One call, that's all. I will always, always trust One Call, that's all.
Injured? Call Gruber Law Offices today. One call, that's all.
They are the best. I'm very happy.
Wisconsin is still cattle country. And that's why Bunzl's chose to stay close to home to hand-select the finest beef. Quality goes into everything they do, from Bunzl's expansive array of meats, homemade specialty sausages, and their award-winning beef jerky. It just isn't a proper holiday meal without Bunzl's top-quality cuts on the dinner table. Tasting is believing. Bunzl's.com.
Don't you wish your life came with a warning app?
That dog does not want to be petted.
Well, life doesn't always give you time to change the outcome, but prediabetes does. Take the one-minute test today at doihaveprediabetes.org. Brought to you by the Ad Council and its Prediabetes Awareness Partners.
You're listening to Wilde and Tausch on 94.5 ESPN. Presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin and sponsored by American Family Insurance.
Live from Buck and Honey's, Jesse and Tausch are there. I am in my basement where I belong. And it's time now for trivia. Let's welcome in our contestants. Oh, it's not a Wednesday, so it's not up his alley per se, but Mailman Matt. Matt, good morning. How are you?
I'm doing great. Safe and sound here in my Bentley Prius.
Nicely done. And Nobody knows the state better. You know all your zip codes. Unfortunately for you, it's not Wednesday. It's not Wisconsin geography. Instead, it is the Packers on the Tailgate Tour trivia. And question number one.
I just realized I forgot the cheese fry helmet at the office. We're going to have to trust Riley to do the drawing today. I had this whole thing planned for you to pick.
Did I not tell you yesterday that you were going to pick?
Dang.
It's not easy to remember cheese fry helmets.
Time for question number one, which goes to Tausch.
All right, mailman. At which university was Mark Murphy the athletic director before becoming the president and CEO of the Packers? Is it Notre Dame? Northwestern? Go ahead. What'd you say?
Northwestern.
There you go.
That's rich.
Nice.
Yeah.
Really nailed that. Jesse putting a zinger in there with the third option,
and
which
he just so happened to not get to it.
I didn't have
by stalling and
nice
stumbling
job, mailman.
The first two answers.
It's because he said Northre Dame for the first one. Which way
away.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. All right, here
done.
We go. Mailman Matt, question number two is this. After playing most of his career for the Packers and one season with the Lions, for which NFL team did Mike Daniels play 13 games over his final 2 years of his NFL career? Mike Daniels finished up with the Baltimore Ravens, the Cincinnati Bengals, or the Cleveland Browns?
Tough question.
It is a tough question.
Yeah.
Stumped.
I mean, Matt thinks it's a tough question, too.
I do. I'm going to go with Cleveland.
Right Wrong-o. State. Right state.
Boy, Riley's really quick with that buzzer. He doesn't even build the suspense.
In fairness, it took a while for Matt to give an answer.
The Cincinnati Bengals were Mike Daniels' final NFL team. Tausch, you have question three for Mailman Matt.
During his two seasons in 2011 and 12 in Green Bay, which jersey number did running back Alex Green wear? Is it 20, 28, or 31?
31.
Jesse, did you have his jersey or something? Because this is not an easy question either.
Well, the third question is not intended to be an easy question. It was number 20. I did not have an Alex Green jersey. Although if I did, I guess I could have brought it to Sun Prairie today for him to maybe sign later.
When you think of the number 20 for the Green Bay Packers, who do you think of?
Kevin King.
I was going to say Atari Bigby was going to be my answer.
Kevin King getting blown away by Scotty Miller up the left sideline right before that halftime of that NFC Championship.
What else do you have to say?
Right there, number 20.
All right. Well, Matt, that didn't go particularly well, but you did get the
first. Seen worse.
question right.
It was worse yesterday.
So you do have two of the possible four entries into what will now be apparently Monday's drawing.
Well, we could let Riley do it if you trust him.
Riley's not ready.
Does Riley have the requisite materials?
He does, and he doesn't need to play any audio from Twitter in order to be able to draw the drawing. You can leave it up to him.
Riley, are you up to the task like you were the Jared Goff audio and a love letter to your girlfriend?
Yeah, I've done this before, so I think I'm game.
See?
You have the chips ready?
Not at the moment. I will rush outside during the break and see if I can figure
it out. Give him 4 minutes. He's got this.
And you need two chips for Mailman Matt now.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
All right. Well, we will. The last time we went to you for some sort of responsibility, the results were mixed. So we will give you the opportunity to totally redeem yourself. Hey, I need to redeem myself too, in fairness, right? Because I was going to talk about some of the cool things that Steinhoffel's had going on yesterday. They were celebrating yesterday National Pet Day, and of all the people to not talk about National Pet Day and Steinhoffel's, for me to miss that yesterday?
That's pretty crazy.
That's a huge failure for me. So we all make mistakes, Riley, including me. But I can remind you that now is the best time to refresh your space during Steinhoffel's best brand sale. You can take an extra 10% off all of their best brands. Cannadel, Gacho, King Hickory, Flex Steel, and more. And they're all at 10% off. And if you need a little help transforming your space, you can save up to $200 on their design services as well. And I'm sorry that you missed National Pet Day at Steinhoffel's. I know Danny, our friend over there, she's not going to be pleased with me. She loves our two dogs, Stella and Sadie. I could have gotten them to contribute, and I blew it. So I apologize to Danny and Chad and the whole crew. They are so great over there and such a great partner. But you can make your space great during the best brand sale. So make sure you shop in-store or online at steinhoffels.com. Whoa, Nelly from Jesse is next. It's Wildy and Tausch.
On air, online, and on demand. Get all your favorite ESPN Wisconsin content anywhere you get your podcasts for free. The new Wisconsin On Demand. It's free, it's everywhere, and it's for you.
Each day, there's a sliver of time when you can almost breathe freely. And you feel better when you can. But you know that eventually that sliver of time closes, along with your nose. It puts a damper on your day every day. So you pop a pill or you take a spray to try to get that relief back. But it's always short-lived. And all the while, in your efforts to give yourself relief, you may be making your nasal breathing problems worse. I'm Dr. Madan Kandula, and a simple in-office procedure from Advent called balloon sinuplasty could be the fast and convenient answer to your breathing triangle problems. Advent has been a leader in this procedure, which can be hard to find elsewhere. It's simple, there's little to no downtime, and it really can be life-changing.
Go to AdventKnows.com to schedule your appointment, because Advent knows when you breathe well, you live better.
Breathe well with simple solutions. Breathe well with simple solutions. AdventKnows.com.
Results may vary.
Hey, Drew Scott here.
And I'm Jonathan Scott, reminding you that life's better with a home policy from American Family Insurance. They can help you get just the right protection at just the right price and help you save when you bundle home and auto. Kind of like Goldilocks and the Three Bears. It'll be just right for you. We love a custom build. American Family Insurance. Insure carefully. Dream fearlessly. Get a quote and find an agent at AmFam.com.
Products not available in every state. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
ESPN Wisconsin's Mark Tauscher here for my friends at Kohler Services. If you need a bath or shower remodel, turn to Kohler Services. Family owned for 150 years, Kohler is your Wisconsin manufacturer providing care for life. And this month only, pay zero interest for 12 months and get a free shower door with your Lugstone shower remodel. Visit KohlerServicesWI.com to request your free quote with fast, professional installation always included. That's KohlerServicesWI.com.
Stay up to date on the Green and Gold all off season. The Green and Gold Fix podcast is brought to you by Potawatomi Casino Hotel. Luxury stay, elite play, unwind in sophisticated comfort. Win big, dine, and experience the events in Milwaukee.
You ever have one of those days when you just couldn't come up with the right answer? Well, I know one answer that pretty much solves all problems. Ice cream. Yeah, it's the answer to everything, right? And right now, at Quick Trip, our rich, creamy, straight from our dairy, Nature's Touch, 1 gallon pails of ice cream are just $4.99. Yeah, now that's an answer worth digging into. Come on, be a problem solver. Bring home some fresh, delicious Nature's Touch ice cream, only from Quick Trip.
Gabe, where do you think our group should be taking our golf trip next year?
Jason, I don't know. Do you have time to figure it all out and get all the reservations made? I certainly don't.
Not really. I mean, I'm so busy. If I only knew somebody to call that might do all the work for us.
Oh, I know about Wisconsin Golf Trips. Their main business is booking groups from around the world to play all the great courses in our state, but they're now doing outbound trips for groups each year to places like Michigan, Minnesota, and Nevada. Plus, Wisconsin Golf Trips is even booking custom packages for Scotland and Ireland.
Oh, wow. Let's hit them up.
WisconsinGolfTrips.com.
People across Wisconsin are enjoying the rewards, stability, and flexibility of a career in healthcare. Why not you? Wish Caregiver Careers can get you started as a certified direct care professional. You'll learn the skills you need to make life better for older adults or people with a disability. All training is free and online, plus earn $500 in bonuses. Start your new career. Sign up today at WISCCDCP.com. Sponsored by the Wisconsin Department of Health Services.
Do you worry about how much someone drinks?
Do you feel neglected or unloved? If you answered yes to any of these questions, you are not alone.
Al-Anon and Alateen can help.
Call 1-866-200-0223 or visit alanon.org/help.
This is Wildy and Tausch on 94.5 ESPN. Sponsored by American Family Insurance. Insure carefully, dream fearlessly. Get a quote and find an agent at amfam.com.
All right, Riley, before we get to Whoa, Nelly, do you have the cheese fry helmet? Are you ready to draw this week's trivia winner?
I am, in fact, ready to draw this week's winner. It is...
A lot of jangling.
Yep. It will be... Coyote Dan in Burlington!
I think it's just Yodi Dan. Yote. I don't think it's Coyote.
You're wrong, too.
What is it, Yote? Well,
Yote.
What did I say? Yote.
You said Yodi.
It should be Yodi.
Yodi Dan.
Nickname has to have two syllables. I don't think you can have a
Tausch?
One nickname. Yeah, I don't. That's not a nickname. It's just you're shorting my last name.
Tauschi?
Some people call me that.
I'm calling for Whoa, Nelly.
If the topic is good, the guys discuss.
Just the other morning, I had breakfast at Tracy Rocker's house. His mama brought out 15 flapjacks. He said, "Mama, take back 5 of them flapjacks. I gotta stay hungry for the Crimson Tide."
But if it's not, the show must go on. It's time for
Whoa, Nelly
on Wildy and Tausch.
Alrighty, so Jesse has given me the reins for Whoa, Nelly today. Yeah, looking forward to it. Whoa, Nelly's a good time.
Riley.
What?
That's great. I'm looking forward to it as well.
Okay, awesome. Thank you. I'm glad. Anyways.
Talk UFC. How's Justin Gaethje looking?
We're getting there. That's my second question.
Oh, God.
We're starting. I was actually inspired during the show. You guys were making fun of Jared Goff's accent and him saying "like" all the time. Like,
well,
that
we never
California.
Got to actually hear it.
Yeah, that's true. But I can do my best impression. That surfer bro, like, whatever, man. I'm just Jared Goff. I'm from California. So I'm wondering.
What?
That's what he sounds like, correct?
I never heard any audio, so I don't know. I only heard Jesse.
I'm Jared Goff, dude.
Jesse's rendition.
He's from Cali.
I'm going to lead the Detroit Lions to Super Bowl.
I'm pretty sure that's exactly what he sounds like. He's from California. So, okay. For you guys, what is the most annoying accent for you guys to listen to?
I think I just heard it. Whatever that just was, put it at the top of my list.
What do you mean, Tosh?
No, you know exactly what I mean. You guys just did it.
Jared Goff. Oh, boy. Should I go back and read what he said and do it in this voice?
Like, yeah, dude.
Why is everyone so down on Detroit, man? We're hosting the draft this year. We got a team that's got the second best odds to win the NFC, dude. Behind only San Francisco, man. Like, totally. We're Jesse, great.
Jesse, I think you've crossed the Rubicon of really irritating Tausch.
No, I'm not irritated. You know how sometimes you get, like, things in your head, like, how the hell did I end up at this point in my life? That's where I'm at right now. What time is it? Yeah, that's where I'm at right now. I'm trying to piece this all together, and that was what was going on in my head.
Dare I say, whoa, Riley.
Whoa, Nelly.
Okay, now it's time for the UFC talk. I know Jason hates when I
whoa,
do this.
Riley.
No, just let me finish, because this goes back to you, Jason, actually. So some context, UFC 300 this weekend, biggest UFC card probably of all time. Last weekend, Combat Sports Entertainment, you had WrestleMania, WWE's biggest, show of the year, whatever you want to call it. And I believe it was Wednesday on KBN, Jason made fun of producer Chris Larson's wrestling name, or... again, whatever you call it. The UFC fighters also typically have those sort of nicknames. Justin Gaethje is the highlight. Justin the Highlight Gaethje is going to go up against Max Blessed Holloway. So, I'm
Blessed?
Wondering...
Yeah. His nickname is Blessed?
Blessed. Max
Two
Blessed Holloway.
Works.
Yeah.
Why haven't we just called Gaethje the Highlight all week? That would have been easier.
Wait, is Blessed two syllables?
Blessed?
Blessed.
I guess if you go Blessed.
Blessed?
Blessed? The best blessed. Is blessed.
I don't think that's okay. Anyway.
So I'm wondering now, Jason, to put it back on you, what would be your either UFC, WWE nickname? Since apparently, I forgot what Chris Larson's was. It was pretty bad. But what would be yours then?
Wouldn't that prove it wasn't good if you can't remember it?
Yeah,
probably.
Yeah.
I think the basement, based on the way that today's show has gone and me staying home, I would take the basement.
That's a good one.
Yeah, thanks.
That is pretty good.
Really okay,
good.
Jesse Tausch.
Go ahead, Jesse. I don't have one.
The Tauschinator.
Wait. We did get that earlier in the show.
That's pretty good.
Jesse?
I've never been in a fight. I don't know. I got nothing. The
10 pin.
You know what? If we want to go Strike Force. 10 pin.
Brooklyn.
Gutter.
Strike Force.
Yeah.
Where are you getting that from?
So, Tausch isn't actually
going to.
Tausch isn't actually going to contribute to any of these. He's just going to rip off.
I'm going Strike Force. I think that's pretty good.
That's actually a fantastic nickname for MMA, Jesse, as there used to be a promotion called Strike Force that eventually merged with the UFC. So, great work there, Jesse.
See?
Shows your knowledge.
Strike Nicely Force done. Versus the Tauschinator.
That'd
UFC 301.
I'd watch that.
That'd be fun.
Want to see the Delegator against the Tauschinator. Whoa, Nelly!
Whoa, Nelly!
Who's the Delegator?
Okay,
I'm being told that's Jesse's nickname. Apparently behind his back.
Mm-hmm. I thought it was
and
the
now
hall
to
monitor.
His face.
The Delegator.
Oh, you delegate a lot?
That's what I'm told I do.
Oh.
I delegate other people to find out if that is what actually happens.
Okay, getting back to some sports that people are more familiar with. The Brewers got rained out yesterday. And anytime the Brewers have a game that's rained out anywhere outside of AmFam, because obviously it can't happen there, Brewers fans go nuts and say everyone else should build a roof on their stadium. So, do you guys believe that every other MLB stadium, save maybe like Yankee Stadium, Fenway, Wrigley, should build retractable roofs on their ballparks?
I mean, I think ideally you would want to have a retractable roof. And the fact that the Brewers did this in 01 and had the foresight to do it was genius. But it's real easy spending other people's money. Real easy. And I think building a retractable roof now is probably, I can't imagine the added expense, because there's teams, you know, the Bears are talking about building a domed stadium for their new field. And you think, well, why not put a retractable roof? Well, it's because it's going to be too cost. It's not cost effective. So I think it's nice to say, do that. But, yeah, all right, if you're going to pitch in a couple hundred million bucks, great. Otherwise, shut your mouth. That's, I think, how the attitude that these teams have.
Tausch, I'm glad you brought up the Bears. I was thinking about that same story. So it apparently has a $2 billion price tag. And it is going to be a dome, not a retractable one. And it's going to be, if it comes to fruition, roughly where Soldier Field is now. What do you make of the fact that they have basically, like Devin Hester on a kickoff return, reversed their field? They were moving out to Arlington Heights not that long ago. They had bought the land and everything else. What do you make of that change?
If you think that that story is written, you're crazy.
I don't.
That's the whole part of you know, we discussed leverage. We discussed all this other stuff. Do I think that they want to be in downtown Chicago? I think they want to get a sweeter deal in Arlington. And I think that's why they're doing this. They're, you know, playing
one against the other.
So how this ends up shaking out, I don't know. But you don't buy a ton of land and see how the Packers do it. New England does it. The Cowboys do it. And have all that real estate that you're able to make a bunch of money on. Do I think that the Bears ownership group or whoever ends up buying them, if the McCaskies sell, that that's the road that they want to go down? I would say yes, because is it going to make me more money? That's the question the owners have. And Arlington will make them a heck of a lot more money, especially if they get a sweetheart deal on the whatever tax breaks they need.
They paid $197 million for the Arlington International Racecourse. Apparently Churchill Downs owned it before, so yep. That's where that Arlington location stands. All right, that's it for Wool Riley.
Jim on the south side points out Tausch is a pirate is the most annoying voice he's ever heard.
Yeah, I could see that. I've never really ever done a good pirate, so I can totally see Jim OTSS point of view on that.
Tausch, you don't use an accent when you talk about Fortria, but it's an important conversation.
Not yet. If you're looking for tickets to Brazil, you want to go down to the game, you're looking for extra spending cash, Fortria's got you covered. Healthy men and women of non-childbearing potential, ages 18 to 60, BMI of 18.5 to 30. They have a study. One stay, 11 nights, couple follow-ups, $5,302 for your time. Another study, healthy males and females of non-childbearing potential as well, ages 18 to 65. This one, body mass index between 18 and 35. That study, one stay of 4 nights, 3 follow-ups, $4,430 for your time and participation. Go to fortriaclinicaltrials.com. That's Fortria, F-O-R-T-R-E-A, clinicaltrials.com.
We wrap up the week and wrap up Jesse and Tausch's visit to Buck and Honey's with Feel Good Friday, painted by Hallman Lindsay Paints. That's next. It's Wilde and Tausch.
Wilde and Tausch continues next on 94.5 ESPN, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin and sponsored by American Family Insurance. Whether it's live or in podcast form, you've heard us on air with all of our shenanigans.
Gabe, I'm throwing some.
Why are you throwing? I don't want.
Now see your favorite 94.5 ESPN show streaming on video.
Made by me, by the way. I hit that microphone like 4 out of 6 times on that.
Subscribe to ESPN Milwaukee on YouTube and get notified when we hit the air live. Plus, you can watch back any second that you miss and see original digital content too. Watch, listen, interact. ESPN Milwaukee on YouTube. It's time for the Ortho ASAP Minute from Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin.
Dr. Daniel Holland from Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin is joining me. Doctor, what makes an OAW surgeon different from most other surgeons?
At Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin, we have all fellowship-trained orthopedic specialists. We have all subspecialties of orthopedics covered through our office, so you can see anybody from the tips of your fingers to the tips of your toes and everywhere in between.
So let's say someone is feeling pain and they finally walk into OAW for that first time. Can you take me through that process of what's going to happen next?
We always start with an office appointment, which will involve me conversing with the patient, trying to figure out what's happening, and then a physical exam. And we have on-site x-ray and on-site MRI if we should need to move into diagnostic tests of that sort.
The Ortho ASAP Minute is sponsored by Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin. There is a difference.
We've told you about Moses Adara,
the diamond cutter who created the Kessler 81.
the magical diamond that vibrates with light.
Kessler's works with crazy diamond cutters.
Geniuses who create wonderful, spectacular,
crazy diamond shapes.
The one thing these crazy genius diamonds all have in common
is that they explode with light.
The Kessler Emerald Cut Diamond sends out rippling waves of light, like water lapping onto a beach.
The Kessler Square Radiant Diamond glows like the sun on the horizon.
Sometimes sunrise,
sometimes sunset.
Come to Kessler's.
Come to Kessler's.
Come to Kessler's.
Ask to see the rippling waves of light, like water on the beach.
Ask to see the glow that looks like sunrise and sunset.
Ask to see the Kessler Crazy Genius Diamonds.
See them for yourself.
See them for yourself.
See them for yourself.
To find the Kessler's nearest you, visit kesslersdiamonds.com.
ESPN Milwaukee Cares is here. Gabe Neitzel is teaming up with the MAC Fund to raise funds and awareness for pediatric cancer research. Here's Gabe Neitzel to tell us more.
The MAC Fund has been fighting the fight against childhood cancer for the last 46 years. All of the proceeds for the MAC Fund go directly to fund research for childhood cancer. If you're unfamiliar with the MAC Fund, that's okay, because President and CEO Becky Pinter of the MAC Fund explains the MAC Fund is simple, and it comes down to one word.
There's so many aspects of the MAC Fund and what we do, but it always boils down to hope. You'll go in my office and there's a number of signs in my office that simply say hope. And we all know what that means. The families, the kids, the doctors, the researchers, the scientists, the nurses, we all have hope for these kids. And we all have hope that we're going to find a cure for pediatric cancer and blood disorders.
To learn more and to donate, text CARES to 800-990-3776.
Hey guys, it's Brad Nortman here to tell you about a great offer at Bank 5-9. I know we're all looking for ways to save our money, and at Bank 5-9, you can earn more by opening a money market account today. With rates as high as 5.3%, you'll earn more while working with a true local community bank. Be sure to check out their great CDs too. Helping you save more of your money is another way Bank 5-9 is making lives better. For details, visit bank59.com/mmspecials. Member FDIC.
You're listening to Wildy and Tausch on 94.5 ESPN. Missed any of the show? Find us on Wisconsin On Demand wherever you get your podcasts. It's free, it's everywhere, and it's for you.
Like I said, when in Durka walk around the neighborhood, feeling blessed, never stressed, got that sunshine on.
It is time for Feel Good Friday, painted by Hallman Lindsay Paints. Are you guys getting lunch after this?
Well, I think we've kind of played.
He's bailing on me.
Yeah, I'm going to bail. We're going to. Jesse and Becca are both going to come to the VIP
ordeal. And Mo?
Over here at 4, a little bit before the big deal over at Angel Park. So we're going to. Mm-hmm. Grab some Buck and Honeys at 4 o'clock.
I don't want to make you jealous, Jason, but there rumors are Becca and Mo are outside right now.
Oh, I am disappointed that I missed out on Mo. I missed out on Tommy. I missed out on Mo.
Mm-hmm.
But what I didn't miss out on was learning more about Sunshine Place, and they are our Feel Good Friday. They are the beneficiaries of the Packers tailgate tour stop in Sun Prairie. And look, Jared Goff can think that the media is too negative, but when it comes to the tailgate tour and the charitable causes that the Packers hit on throughout the state, every single year with their stops.
Yeah, they don't have to do this stuff.
They don't.
They are going to sell. The stadium's going to be sold out. They're going to have all that stuff. They don't need to. And so you have to give major props to Mark and to Kathy and to the whole community development team, because they're very proactive and, you know, obviously making huge impacts in all of these spots that they hit.
Bob Harlan started it once upon a time. You went on the tour with him, but Mark Murphy and Kathy Dworak and the whole crew at 1265 Lombardi Avenue has taken it to an entirely different level. And one of the many, many causes that benefit from it is Sunshine Place. And you heard Tommy from Buck and Honey's talk about it earlier. He's on the board there. But Sunshine Place supports services for families and individuals who are facing food insecurity, housing instability, and other barriers to family and household stability. One location where families and individuals in Sun Prairie and Eastern Dane County can access community resources and opportunities. Did you know that 1 in 14 adults and 1 in 9 children goes hungry in Wisconsin every day? Sunshine Place strives to enhance the health of their neighbors in need with supplemental food and meals. They also shine hope and help the children facing hardships. If you want to find out more about everything they do, certainly they'll have an opportunity to share what they do at the tour stop for the tailgate tour later today at Angel Park. But you can visit sunshineplace.org. That's sunshineplace.org to learn more about all the great stuff they do. We thank Tommy for being such a great host as well for Jesse and Tausch at Buck and Honey's, and we look forward to everything else that the Packers and Buck and Honey's and ESPN Madison have planned for later in the day when the Packers stop by. Tausch?
I'm getting a little nervous. So Becca's out there with old boy. And my wonderful young daughter, who has been pushing very, very hard to get
with a dog, my support,
she loves dogs, and
they look like they're having the time of their life right now.
I think there's going to be a point where I'm in a cave. I don't know when yet, but I'm getting there's a lot of joy dogs
mark
bring.
The tape.
Yeah, I've said that before. So for as staunchly as I've fought this, I'm getting much closer to getting
You're such a softie, and I love it.
Trust me, that's not the case. But I think there's a lot of positives, and I just see her. Look at how happy she is up there.
Oh, she's doing tricks with them.
Yeah, looks pretty fun.
All right, well, we look forward to her getting her puppy, you guys spending your time with Mo and Becca, and all the great things that are going on in Sun Prairie today as the Packers tailgate tour makes its stop at Angel Park. Thanks for coming along for the ride with us today. Thanks to Rasheed Walker. Thanks to Rob Domofsky. Thanks to Tommy Anderson, and thanks to you. Have a great day. Enjoy your weekend. Take care. Be good.
Miss any of today's episode of Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin? Commercial-free full show podcasts are available free on Wisconsin On Demand.
And ESPN Radio Extra Point. With Evan Cohen, Chris Canty, and Michelle Smallman.
Why would Coach Cal leave a blue blood program like Kentucky to go to Arkansas? A seemingly lesser job, a lower profile job. I don't understand it. I get that the fans of Big Blue Nation had the pitchforks out there and they were all ready to have his head served up on a silver platter, but he had a $33 million buyout. He wasn't going anywhere. Like, he had the meeting with the athletic director a couple of weeks ago, and the two sides decided to mend fences, and we thought that meant Coach Cal was going to be on a short leash going into the upcoming season, but apparently he decided, I don't want to be in that situation. I don't want to be left in the lurch. I'm going to go for greener pastures right now. I can't get past this thought in my head that maybe, just maybe, the shine has come off of Kentucky basketball in terms of being one of the upper echelon programs in the sport.
Prescriptions require an online consultation with a healthcare provider who will determine if appropriate restrictions apply. See website for details and important safety information. Subscription required. Price varies based on product and subscription plan.
Hey guys, did you know there's a generic form of Viagra that works just the same but is 95% cheaper? And you can get it online at hims.com/joy. Through Hims, you'll get a free medical consultation to determine the ED medication that's best for you. Discreet shipping if prescribed, a 100% online process, and a range of treatment options, including trusted generic alternatives to the name brands, at up to 95% off. ED is personal, and at Hims,
is SportsCenter.
I'm Christine Lisi. Tiger Woods finished up his weather-delayed first-round 73 this morning at the Masters, 8 back of leader Bryson DeChambeau. Tiger's slated to tee off his second round in 18 minutes. Scottie Scheffler's one off the lead. Live coverage continues on ESPN+. Main coverage, 3 Eastern on ESPN. Kentucky's finalizing a 5-year deal with BYU's Mark Pope to make him its next basketball coach, according to ESPN's Pete Thamel and Jeff Borzello. Pope's a 1996 Kentucky grad and won a national title there. Wildcats turned to Pope Pope after several high-profile candidates either turned down the job or declared they were not interested. NBA Timberwolves center Karl Anthony Towns expected to return tonight against the Hawks, reports ESPN's Adrian Wojnarowski. He had surgery on a meniscus tear in his left knee 4 weeks ago. Minnesota and OKC tied for second in the West, a game back of Denver.
ESPN Studios at Pier 17 in the Seaport District of New York City. This is Greeny with Mike Greenberg on ESPN Radio. You can also listen and watch the show on the ESPN app.
Yes. So crazy right now.
Okay, welcome to the show. It is Greeny here on ESPN Radio and the ESPN app, presented by Progressive Insurance, along with Hembo. Evan going in for Greeny today. Oh, my God. A lot going on today. We are pumped up. We got the Masters going on right now. ESPN, ESPN Plus, ESPN Deportes with all of the coverage. Final weekend of the NBA season. We've got the latest on Shohei Ohtani and his interpreter, as well as a brand new basketball coach at Kentucky. But, Hembo, we are officially friends.
We lunched.
We lunched.
We lunched, and the duration of the lunch, Cam and Bubba, you'll be happy to hear, lasted longer than 1 hour.
It did.
So we are officially in the friend zone.
Yes, we are. And you have noted, which I find very interesting, that on our show rundown, one Cam Pratt has officially been broken. Explain why.
So Cam Pratt, noted big sports fan and noted not so big Hembo and Evan, bull bleeping fan, decided even so to lead the show with our one place to start being our lunch, which can only mean, Evan, we have prevailed. That we have finally broken.
It's a losing battle, boys.
The ultra serious sports fan, Cam Pratt.
All right. So let's dive into this.
Yeah.
We do the show yesterday, which was certainly a unique show with the death of O.J. Simpson that happened during the course of the show yesterday. And we left the building, and Hembo, who used to live near here at the Seaport, picked a place to go to. It's a good place, kind of a sports bar-y kind of place. We walk in. The place is so dark, we cannot see each other when we walk in. The music is so loud, we could not hear each other when we were there. And his goal was to find out if any of the televisions were either delayed on the app or maybe running a rerun of Get Up so he could see himself.
My favorite thing to do is to be in a sports bar with a rerun of Get Up and for me to be watching it and for someone in the sports bar to notice that the guy on TV is the guy sitting next to him. We didn't pull it off yesterday because we weren't at the bar itself, but it is a very conceited thing that I pursue.
Yes. In addition, he picked a table which had his seat elevated and my seat lowered. So in this pitch black sports bar with music so loud, he's literally looking down on me both literally and physically.
Yeah. I like it. Asserting some dominance.
Yeah, so everything that I do is intentional. There's nothing in life, at least nothing that matters, that I ever do that is unintentional. So everything about this lunch was set up for me to thrive, for me to have the upper hand.
Right.
And that's exactly what happened.
Well, okay, and then we sat down, and he's looking down on me, and we were just reviewing a couple of notes from about the show because it was one of the most unique shows either of us have ever been a part of, right? You don't have a Hall of Fame football player, Heisman Trophy winner, alleged murderer die while you're in the doing a show too often. And let's hope that never happens again because we're not looking for people to get murdered. And we had the conversation about, hey, we think we handled this pretty well. He then says to me, no offense, I can be good with anyone. Okay, well, that took my legs out from underneath me as the fill-in guy.
I said no offense.
You think there's no offense to the idea that you could just be good with anyone?
No, what's the point of using the phrase no offense if not to not offend you?
But I have something different that I do. I actually lead with offense. If I'm going to be offensive, I'm going to tip you off.
It wasn't offensive.
It's kind of offensive.
It was a statement of fact. I thought we did a great show, and I thought I could have done a great show independent of who was on the other side.
But I'm sitting there with you as you're saying that.
So I should say that to someone else about you.
Probably. I guess I appreciate.
By the way, Cam, honesty. This was before the waiter had even showed up.
Yes.
That is true.
This is an eventful lunch.
Yeah. We haven't even started.
We haven't even started the lunch.
And then, before I hand it off to Hembo, for the actual lunch part, we're just in the pregame at this point. at this point, I get a text message from my buddy Mark Silverman, Waddle and Sylvie, ESPN 1000.
Kind of like that guy. I kind of like that guy.
So I said to Hembo, wow, got a really nice text from Sylvie just now. By the way, he loves you. Thinks you're great. Normally someone, a human, breathing, normal person, non-alien, would say, wow, that's awesome. Somebody that is that nice, has been through an amazing amount of things in his life, that is that courageous, is that talented, is that successful, is that kind of family man, and great in this industry. Normally someone would then say, wow, that's really nice. I appreciate that. Thanks so much. His response to me saying that Sylvie thinks he's great, I gathered that.
I could not possibly have been less gracious.
You were right about that.
The worst thing about all of this is that, Cam, Bubba, these are just my instincts. Like, there's nothing nefarious here. There's nothing put on here. Like, I'm just saying the thing that first comes to mind. It's not, oh, I feel the same way about that guy. Or, that's super nice of him to say. It's, oh, yeah, I already knew that he thought that highly of me. I'm just the worst friggin' guy.
Can you imagine saying that to someone when someone is kind enough to say things nice about you and your response is, I gathered that?
like I didn't even need you to share.
No.
I already knew.
No.
I already knew that Sylvie loved me.
Yes. So we now have the menus in front of us. The waiter comes over. Yes, go
Christ,
ahead.
Very oddly, I might
I've
add.
Never seen, great observation, even though I made it. I've never seen anything like this. They had cash prices and credit card prices on this menu for different items. So, and they weren't like significantly different. It was like grilled chicken sandwich, $12 for cash, $12.43 for a credit card. Why even bother putting that on there? The 43 cent difference for cash versus credit they have on the menu. I've never seen anything like that.
It was so weird. Like, I've been to places.
Being transparent.
Yeah, you're being transparent.
I gather that.
But Bubba, the differences were inconsequential. Never more than $1.
It's a very small difference.
Right.
I certainly agree with that.
So, like, yes, it's very honest, but, like, I think all of that could have gone without being said. That's my opinion about the menu.
Yeah, I mean, I would expect if they're going to do that, it's going to be a larger gap. But...
Exactly right.
right.
Exactly right.
And this is when the first cardinal sin occurred.
Okay.
Bubba. All right. He did the thing that you cannot do. He ordered the exact same thing I did. And I could tell he didn't want to.
That is
cardinal
such a
sin
lie.
Number one.
That is
broken.
Such a lie. Cardinal sin one. We went to. I don't even know if I heard your order. It was so loud in that restaurant. I didn't. I could barely see the menu. I just looked. I saw chicken and I ordered it. I was going to order that. You happened to order first. I didn't order it because of you.
No.
I did chuckle.
No.
Knowing we were about to order the same thing.
None of this is true. Like
it
you
was
don't have
good,
to,
by the way.
You don't. It was good.
Yeah. Good
it
sandwich.
Was pretty good. You don't have to be dishonest with our audience here because
I'm dishonest. You're being dishonest about me being dishonest.
No, you're not. You're not telling the truth.
I am telling the truth.
But here's why I know he's not telling the truth. First of all, when the waiter came by and asked if we'd like anything to drink, I said water's fine. He took a second. Yeah, water's fine for me too.
So I was no. Oh my god.
Did anything I just said untrue?
Keep going. I want to hear where this goes before I say it.
Sounds like he can hear you.
Okay. Yeah, he could vaguely hear. So, Evan, if you wanted to drink something other than water.
I didn't.
Decided not to, directly because I only drank water. Secondly, I order the Caribbean jerk sandwich, okay? I order it with a side salad instead of fries. Mm-hmm. Evan gets the same sandwich with nothing on it, so he didn't like the sandwich. He didn't want the sandwich. He cleaned it. It was bread and chicken.
And cheese.
Bread and dry chicken and cheese.
That's what I eat.
No topping.
Anyone that's listening that knows me knows that is literally what I eat.
And then gets the side salad and set of fries and says to the waiter, I'm doing that because if I don't get the salad, that guy will judge me.
Oh, no, that's true.
All of it's true.
Well, if I got fries, you would judge me.
Yeah, but I mean,
yeah, but that's the point.
No, it's
I don't
want to
be judged.
You should eat what you want to eat.
I can't you in
got
front
this,
of you.
You didn't just get the same sandwich as me. You also got a salad instead of fries because of me.
I can't eat what I want to eat because of you.
You should have ordered first.
You're too judgmental, and I'm too insecure. It's a bad combination.
But you're in good shape. You're doing just fine for yourself. Why are you insecure about eating French fries at lunch?
It's not that I'm insecure about eating French fries. I mean, I'm insecure about eating French fries with you. Because you're a judger of others.
All right, I got to jump in here and ask a question. Evan, during this lunch, tweeted at 12:24 p.m., 1:05 p.m., 1:06 p.m., 1:17 p.m., and the lunch seemed to conclude at 1:28 p.m.
Right.
Hembo responded to one of these tweets at 12:25 p.m., the first tweet that you sent. Did you guys talk at all, or were we just tweeting play-by-play forth to each other during the lunch?
I'm glad you asked.
I know you couldn't hear each other, so there might not have been a point in talking at all, but it seemed like you were just on your phones tweeting what was happening, even though nothing was really happening.
Cam, great observation, great question. You are a very smart man. We know that. Did we talk at lunch? Let me just make one slight alteration. I was able to tweet because someone was talking the entire time with not a single question mark used ever. Meaning, Hembo asked me nothing. Hembo had an agenda to a point that when we got done with this lengthy, professional, healthy conversation that we had, he said, I had one other thing for you. So he could claim that he was not ready for this lunch or mad that I sent a calendar invite. He had an agenda.
I did. And that
there was an agenda on the
by
lunch.
By the way, Cam, and the thing that I had forgotten until one was I wanted his help to get me on MLB Network.
That is true. You waited. Okay. I wasn't going to bring that up, but you okay.
Oh, I don't care.
He waited an hour. And I realized what the lunch was about. I thought we've been working together. We now are friends because of the big lunch. I didn't pick up on what this lunch was always about. It had nothing to do with getting to know me better. It had nothing to do with us getting to know each other better. It simply had to do with the fact, I was never going to bring this up, I'm so glad you did, that for the last 12 years prior to coming here to ESPN, where did I work? I worked at SiriusXM's Mad Dog Sports Radio. We are on SiriusXM Channel 80 as we speak. He literally said to me after an hour, you know Mad Dog well, don't you? I said, yeah, I mean.
What a non sequitur. Yeah.
He said, do you think you can help me get on High Heat? And I said, I'm sorry, what? That's his television show on MLB television. To which he then says, I think he likes me.
Yeah, I gathered that.
Damn, I looped him up for an hour to try to get on High Heat.
I never